No one's ever come as close as Shawn Michaels did last year to defeating The Undertaker at WrestleMania. Streak as The Undertaker faced the same man two consecutive years. He's doing it now with Shawn Michaels.
Has Shawn Michaels found something? Is there one thing that The Undertaker does that Shawn Michaels will capitalize on?
Oh! Shawn Michaels said he wouldn't risk anything, everything, if he couldn't beat The Undertaker.
But right now, The Undertaker hell bent
on beating Michaels.
This match is starting all out, and it, oh my God!
Yeah, snake eyes early from The Undertaker. You don't often see that. And Shawn Michaels suddenly in deep trouble at the hands of the Phenom.
Oh, watch this.
Michaels looked like he blocked Undertaker for a moment from going to old school, and Undertaker right back on the attack.
Let's watch the pure strength of The Undertaker here. Old school.
Oh, connected.
Wow, it looks like Undertaker might have done something to his knee right there.
But nonetheless, he's focusing on Shawn Michaels. Michaels in trouble. Undertaker maybe going for a choke slam. Looking to put Michaels away early. Oh. And Michaels with a counter.
Oh.
And the Heartbreak Kid on the attack.
I think that definitely something happened to The Undertaker's knee when he came off that rope. I don't think he was able to lift Shawn. I think his knee gave out as he tried to choke slam Shawn.
And notice how Shawn Michaels focused his attack on the knee of The Undertaker. Undertaker, though, gonna put Michaels away. Michaels going for Tombstone, perhaps. Shawn Michaels with a counter.
Now, Michael, you talked about all of the weapons that The Undertaker brings to the contest. How do you feel that gives The Undertaker an advantage?
I think The Undertaker can put away Shawn Michaels any way possible. Anything from a Hell's Gate submission to the chokeslam to the last ride to the Tombstone pile driver.
Well, let's not forget, I followed Shawn Michaels' career. Shawn Michaels has used a cross face and ankle lock. Shawn Michaels is very, very apt in the art of submission grappling.
And he may need it in this matchup that can only end via pinfall or submission.
Yeah, guys, let's not forget the super kick.
And there it was, sweet chin music. And Undertaker. Notice how right back to the injured left knee.
I think this does not bode well for The Undertaker, because I think Shawn notices that.
Yeah,
knee.
Did you notice the look in Michaels'
look
eyes?
Shawn, go for a
he
leg
saw
dive.
Undertaker go to the knee. And Shawn went right after the knee.
Shawn Michaels has one chance at greatness, one chance to do the one thing that no one else has ever done. Shawn Michaels and The Undertaker one more time.
And this could be Shawn Michaels' opportunity.
Uh-oh. How does this change the entire scope of this emotionally fueled contest?
Changes the entire complexion of the matches. Michaels is now focused his attack on a knee tweaked earlier on by The Undertaker. Look at the Phenom. So much riding on this match for both of these men. Career versus streak.
It is one of the most revered streaks in all of sports. Think of some of the great streaks. DiMaggio's 56-game hitting streak. Oral Hershiser's scoreless streak. Undertaker's streak is legendary.
Nothing compares to the streak, the 17-0 streak of The Undertaker.
Yeah, but you guys are talking about the streak, and certainly it's impressive. I mean, it's unparalleled, but let's talk about the career of Shawn Michaels.
Let's talk about what The Undertaker's thinking about doing here.
The knee.
And Shawn Michaels right back into the ring. Michaels saw The Undertaker's look, and he capitalized and countered and delivered a shoulder to the injured knee of the Phenom.
I think that's...
Hey, King, this is great strategy for Shawn Michaels. When you're facing a bigger opponent, you got to knock him down to size.
Exactly.
And Shawn Michaels looked like he was maybe going for the figure four in Undertaker counter.
I thought earlier Undertaker was going to go for that dive, that patented dive over the top rope. I don't know if his knee would have held up to get airborne like that.
Shawn Michaels wasn't going to allow it to happen. Again, another thing Shawn Michaels has learned over the years, including last year, is Undertaker drives Michaels spine first to the steel.
Now you see the Undertaker focusing on that that famous back of Shawn Michaels. We all know the history there.
Shawn Michaels' injured back cost him 5 years of his career. Undertaker knows that well.
Guys, I love the strategy. An injured limb definitely takes away the choke slam, the last ride, the tombstone, and the Hell's Gate from the Undertaker.
Yeah, but right now it's the Undertaker who's got strategy in mind as he delivers a vicious and vintage leg drop.
Boy, this has got to be disheartening to the Undertaker.
And remember, gentlemen, Undertaker can do anything he wants to Shawn Michaels outside the ring because of the stipulation in this matchup. You got to win by pinfall or submission.
You know, the main thing that had to be on the mind of the Undertaker when you're talking about, when you're thinking about devising your strategy for a match as big as this is, you've got to stay healthy. You've got to try to avoid injury. And what happens right off the bat? Undertaker suffers a knee injury.
Yeah, Michaels goes right for the injured leg. Got it. Four leg lock locked in. Will Undertaker tap out to Shawn Michaels?
Could you imagine that?
Notice the Undertaker keeping his hand. He took his hand off of Shawn. Now the maneuver is fully sunk in.
And Shawn Michaels with everything he's got.
What do you say?
Listen, the Undertaker writhing in pain.
I mean, it could happen, but I can't imagine seeing the Undertaker tap out.
Well, you know, the Undertaker's tolerance for pain is legendary, but how much can he take? Shoulders down. You saw the look in the eyes of the Phenom. Look at Shawn Michaels wearing down the Undertaker. How much more can the Phenom take? Will he tap out? Will the streak end?
Look at this. Look at this look on the Undertaker's face. It's
reversing
pain.
The pressure.
It's rage. It's determination all at once. Look at the Undertaker, as you say, reversing that pressure.
And Shawn Michaels finally breaks the hold, realizing he was the man in trouble. 72,219 looking on at the most anticipated match in the history of WrestleMania.
Well, you can see it here. Undertaker's going to have to come up with a whole new strategy. He's going to have to go on the defensive if he's to survive this.
Undertaker unloading with a right hand. Michaels as well, but Michaels does not want to get in a slugfest with the best pure striker in the history of the WWE.
You're right. I mean, I don't even know if the Undertaker knows how to be defensive.
I think a wounded Undertaker is a dangerous Undertaker.
I agree with you there.
Wow.
Michaels. Shawn Michaels countering the Undertaker at every turn thus far.
Michael, you say that the Undertaker is the best pure striker in the WWE. No one will disagree with you. But an injured limb takes away your ability. An injured leg, you lose your base. You can't throw those big right hands as well as you normally would be able to.
And Michaels, kick up. And how many times have we seen that?
He is
risen. Have we seen this? Slam! Is the career over? Is the career over for Shawn Michaels? Oh, and a kick out.
Oh, he is risen. Just believe. And right as we believe, the Undertaker takes it right away.
Now, that was so close. So close for Shawn Michaels' career to be over here tonight.
Well, you got to know the determination that's in the heart of HBK.
And Undertaker. And Michaels trying to battle back, trying to battle out. Oh, no! Undertaker was going for the turnstile pile driver. And Shawn Michaels.
There is the ankle lock submission.
And Michaels on the injured leg of the Undertaker has the ankle lock locked in. Will the Undertaker now tap out?
I have been locked in this hold. The pressure on the ankle and the knee. How is the Undertaker withstanding this pain?
Oh, my gosh. Look at the Undertaker's foot. It's not meant to bend that way.
And you can hear the Undertaker screaming, no, no, as Michaels pulls it back into the center of the ring.
Compounding the pressure by hyperextending the knee.
Undertaker writhing in agony.
Look at the way Shawn's legs are locked as well.
The determination on the face of Shawn Michaels.
I just still can't imagine the Undertaker.
Look at shoulders.
Maybe even with a broken ankle, I can't imagine the Undertaker tapping out in WrestleMania. Can you? I can't imagine.
Not at all. Not any of the streak on a submission. I don't think anybody can see that coming. Undertaker trying to do what he can.
Oh! Near 7 foot frame coming into play. Those long legs of the Undertaker.
And those big feet finding their mark on the side of Shawn Michaels' head.
It has been such a physical battle since the beginning of this match.
Has so much emotion here. We're talking about, you know, we're talking about that streak, but what about Shawn's career? I mean, oh, they're both outside. Shawn Michaels been obsessing about this match for over a year, just thinking about trying to end the Undertaker's undefeated streak, but then suddenly this match becomes about ending his career.
Well, Kid, let's face it. You know what the Undertaker's undefeated streak means to him, but it can't mean as much as it does to the career of that man.
He caught
Shawn Michaels, who was caught in midair.
Unbelievable strength and resiliency from the Undertaker.
And look at Shawn Michaels trying to fight out. Fight out. Oh, my God.
This could be it. WrestleMania, the chance to live forever.
Could be it. It's got to be it. Shawn's head bounced off the floor.
But remember, you cannot win this matchup via countout. You've got to win the match via pinfall or submission. The Tombstone Piledriver has damaged Shawn Michaels, but it has not allowed The Undertaker to take advantage yet. A Tombstone Piledriver outside the ring. That's how much the streak means to The Undertaker.
And somehow The Undertaker has got to hit Shawn Michaels. Shawn's unconscious. Barely moving now, but The Undertaker's got to get him inside the ring somehow.
Like I was saying before, Ken, you know how much the streak means to The Undertaker, but not as much as what the career means to Shawn Michaels.
Right.
Undertaker not even allowing the doctors, the medical staff to attend to Shawn Michaels, getting Shawn back in the ring. Looking to put Michaels away, into the cover, by the leg. Is the career over? No!
Emotionally, there's so much at stake. We may never have this opportunity in this environment with these two superstars ever again. Thank you, gentlemen. Look at this.
Watch this. Watch Shawn's head hit the floor. Oh! If The Undertaker had been able to get Shawn in the ring immediately after that, this would be over right now.
Remember, Undertaker and Shawn Michaels, who've had a storied rivalry over the years. Perhaps none bigger than last year's 25th anniversary of WrestleMania. Until this moment, streak versus career as Undertaker wants to put Shawn Michaels away.
Here we go.
Michaels in trouble, going for the last ride is The Undertaker. Michaels is in deep, deep trouble.
Michaels was able to counter.
But wait a minute. I don't know if it was a counter or the fact that The Undertaker's leg buckled. Here's the cover. Two count, kick out.
I don't know what happened either. They both fell awkwardly. Let's see.
Let's
again.
Take a look.
See
what
I think it's The Undertaker's injured leg. Look at the buckle there.
No, and I think Shawn grabbed The Undertaker's hair and drove Undertaker's face into
or
the mat at the same time.
Combination of both.
And now look.
Shawn Michaels.
Oh, boy.
To the top rope.
Trying to capitalize here.
With the WWE Universe in the background. Looking on. Shawn Michaels.
But how much did that take out of The Undertaker's injured leg?
Undertaker countered, preserving an elbow to the heart. Oh, what a match.
Yeah. I don't know what it took out of The Undertaker's legs, but it looks as though Shawn Michaels is now injured as well. Watch the legs come up. Oh, right into the ribs of Shawn Michaels. But desperate times call for desperate
measures. Hell's Gate! 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 Undertaker looking to lock it in. And Michaels counters. Shoulders down. Oh. And a kick out of two. Can you believe that? What a counter by Shawn Michaels. No one has ever countered the Hell's Gate, I believe.
I've been in that move. You immediately pass out, and Shawn Michaels knew the severity of the situation.
Shawn just grasping for any part of The Undertaker he can get his hands on now. Oh, thrown off.
Is the streak over?
That is it.
Is the streak over? Is it over? No.
What? Talk about out of nowhere. Listen. Whoa. Nobody saw that coming. certainly not The Undertaker, but he felt every bit of it. How did he kick? How did The Undertaker kick out of that?
Sweet chin music connected. Now Shawn Michaels tuning up the band again. Gentlemen, he may have the opportunity to do what no other man has ever done at WrestleMania. End the streak of The Undertaker as he tunes up the band.
Could it be a graveyard symphony?
Oh, and Undertaker countered,
blocked it, blocked it. Caught him.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. Michaels up high.
This is it.
Oh! Is it the end of Michaels' legendary career?
No. We've auditioned our entire lives for this moment.
Well, The Undertaker said Shawn Michaels' obsession would cause him to pay the ultimate price. Was that price the last ride?
I don't think I've ever seen that last ride delivered more emphatically, more perfectly, and it didn't get the job done.
Undertaker almost can see the wheels turning. What does he need to do to put away the legendary Shawn Michaels?
I mean, so many thoughts have got to be going through The Undertaker's mind. I saw him slap his own knee a second ago. It's like he's mad at himself for that injury. He's frustrated. He's this pent-up emotion. What's he going to do here? Whoa!
Boom! Well, remember, King, Shawn Michaels has no alternative but to defeat The Undertaker. This isn't about winning a match. This is about saving a fabled 25-year career.
Oh, no.
Oh, watch out here, guys.
Oh, Lord.
Well, there goes our announce table.
Well, this is just an example of what keeping the legendary streak intact means for the Phenom. Trying to knock feeling back into his leg. Undertaker knows he must win via pinfall or submission. No countouts, no disqualifications here. And I don't know if we picked that up, ladies and gentlemen. I believe Undertaker said, I'm gonna end this thing right here, right now. Going for the last ride. Michaels from behind!
Sweet chin music! Yeah, but The Undertaker's not in the ring. He can't pin him out here on the table.
But what can he do?
Michaels crawling to the apron. Undertaker's body strewn on the announce table. Michaels gingerly making his way to the top rope.
What is he doing? What is Shawn thinking here?
Oh, my Lord. Michaels, top rope. Undertaker.
Oh, my God.
Right here in front of us, grabbing and grasping at that injured leg.
I think his leg's broke.
Undertaker's leg's broke. Shawn Michaels flailing around before coming to a stop outside the ring.
Look at The Undertaker's face. I swear, I think his leg's broke.
Shawn Michaels putting it all on the line. Could this be the moment that we have all waited for?
Undertaker, battle wounds and scars have formed.
Get out of the way, Michael.
Get out of the way. Body.
Watch, he's...
Undertaker trying to crawl away up the barricade. Michaels desperately trying to take advantage of an injured Phenom.
I don't think Undertaker knows where he is.
It doesn't matter. This is what this is about, King. Michaels is trying to take advantage, trying to desperately take advantage of the injury to The Undertaker. Looking to put The Undertaker away.
I think the streak is over. I think Undertaker's leg is snapped.
Undertaker can't stand. Neither can Michaels. Shawn Michaels.
Watch it.
Sweet chin music. It's over. The
streak is over! The streak is over! Michaels has done it! No!
What? What?
How on earth did The Undertaker kick out of Sweet Chin Music?
How on earth does The Undertaker do anything that he does in the ring?
Take a look here. Where else will you find this kind of emotion, this kind of passion? It only happens at WrestleMania.
These fans behind me are chanting, "This is awesome," and you are right.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are so close to The Undertaker and Shawn Michaels. You can literally see their bodies shaking, twitching, in pain, in emotion. Michaels back to his feet first. He is stalking. He is tuning up the band. He's looking to put the feet on the way. Sweet Chin Music.
No, 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 no.
Choke slam.
Oh, my God. How does he do it on that leg? How did The Undertaker deliver that choke slam? But can he get the cover?
Can Undertaker pin Shawn Michaels here? Will he end the storied career?
I don't know if Undertaker can even stand on that leg.
Shawn Michaels has not moved since the choke slam. Oh, my. How is Undertaker standing?
I don't know. Why did he just try to cover him?
Oh, no. Undertaker again going for a tombstone pile driver. Trying to try the career of Michaels into the burial plot.
This is it.
The career of Shawn Michaels is over. Oh, no. He kicked out.
70,000 plus on their feet.
Shawn Michaels will not surrender.
The
Shawn Michaels has no quit.
The Phenom cannot believe it. Nor can I. Nor can his 70,000 fans.
Undertaker, disbelief for the first time in his career, crossing his face. You can feel the emotion seeping through the pores of over 72,000 fans here in Phoenix. No one wants the streak to end. No one wants the career to end. Something has to give at WrestleMania.
I'm just trying to read the thoughts, the emotion on the face of The Undertaker. What is he thinking now? Is he having self-doubts? Is he wondering, does he have what it takes to put Shawn Michaels away? Or is he just trying to think of his next assault?
I think The Undertaker realizes he is in the ring with his toughest opponent ever.
Michaels is twisted. Michaels' body is bent. Perhaps respect shown for the career of Shawn Michaels.
Listen.
defiant to the end, Shawn Michaels. I believe tonight we saw that
and more.
Much, much more.
Oh, way surpassed what anyone could have expected. A match of this magnitude, so much riding on it. And what a match it was, a classic for all time. Both of these great superstars just completely spent, but I just can't believe that Shawn Michaels' career is over.
The Undertaker's legendary 18-0 streak is intact. But at what cost? The cost of the legendary Shawn Michaels' career.
Well, I mean, in the end, we heard Shawn Michaels being told by The Undertaker to stay down. Look at this. Shawn, as you said, Michael, defiant. I mean, you know, signaling the end of himself and then slapping The Undertaker in the face. Oh, now what?
kids nuts in 3 weeks.
He looks ready to defend that championship. But John Cena looks ready as well.
Rock won the title back at the Royal Rumble from CM Punk. John Cena said this will be his year. He won the Royal Rumble. He knocked off CM Punk in a huge match on Raw a couple of months ago to ensure this matchup
here
would take
go.
Place. And here we go. Rock versus Cena. WWE title.
I gotta tell you, the hair standing up on the back of my neck just a little bit.
This is history, King. Career-defining moment for both.
Very important match for Cena. A must-win. Cena's shoulder tackle. Draws first blood in the match.
Just getting your feet wet. Testing the water.
No secret what happened last year. One of the most disappointing moments in the life of John Cena. A loss to The Rock, which led to a downward spiral, both in his career and his professional life. Today, he hopes to right all those wrongs. And again, collar and elbow tie up center of the ring into a side headlock by the champion, The Rock. With a shoulder tackle, and now we've got a stalemate.
Once again, Michael, this is the feeling out process here.
John Cena won his first WWE Championship at WrestleMania 21 in Los Angeles when he defeated the man to my right, John Bradshaw Layfield.
But the Cena you see here today is not the Cena I face. This Cena is so much better than the one in 2004. This Cena is better than the one that you saw last year at WrestleMania. This has been a year he has worked for redemption.
A year of focus and determination. Cena leapfrog. Goes in and off the hip toss, the line. And Cena looks for a breather.
Cena knows he's a future Hall of Famer, but if he loses to The Rock twice at WrestleMania back-to-back, there will always be the big game stigma against him.
I think it's maybe even more than that. I think another loss to The Rock would be devastating for the psyche of John Cena.
Exactly. Rock won his first WWE title, 1998 Survivor Series. Well documented, he left WWE for a number of years. He returned as a huge box office star, returning to reclaim the WWE Championship.
The Rock beat Austin and Hogan at WrestleMania. He beat Cena last year, he beats him again. He has to be considered the greatest of the modern era. That is what is at stake here, guys. Your place in history.
The John Cena's had incredible WrestleManias, WWE titles, world titles, US titles. A victory over The Rock tonight would cement his legacy and offer him redemption. So Cena calculated, measuring Rock.
Each one of these guys just wanted to get the upper hand here, wanted to set the pace. Rock may be doing it now with his big right hand.
Yeah, look at Rock fire back.
Saw a few wrestling moves back and forth, but then the Rock pulls out the hardware here.
These two respect each other, but they don't like each other. A lot of personal differences over the years.
And you know what's strange about that is you guys, the three of us, know more than anyone, probably. These guys are both such likable guys. I mean, there's not a better guy in the locker room than John Cena to be around. He's so approachable. You know, anybody can walk up and talk to John. He's just such a good guy. Rock's the same way.
But it's about competition and the desire and drive to be the best ever. That's right. What this is about.
King, I agree with you, but these are two alpha males. These are two super egos.
You're right.
Very few times do you have the best of a generation fighting in the prime of their life.
And we see it with a clothesline.
That's what we have right here.
Here's the cover by Cena for the championship.
But in some of those conversations that I've had over the year with John Cena, that's where I get the feeling that another loss to The Rock would be devastating.
Well, King, I mentioned it before. It wasn't just John's professional life. His personal life
exactly.
As well. And he went into a downward spiral. He admitted that. He wasn't the same for a year. And when the first of this year came around, he decided he was going to make 2013 John Cena's year, make himself whole again. And he can do that tonight. That's what's on the line for John.
Yeah, but Cena still has an illustrious career, Michael, a Hall of Fame career. If he shakes off that loss, this guy might be considered the greatest of our generation. That's what we have at stake. It's who's going to be on wrestling's Mount Rushmore.
If he shakes off that loss, but what would happen if he suffers another loss?
Then he has an asterisk by his name forever.
That's what
he becomes the Jim Kelly of the WWE. He becomes a Hall of Famer who can't win the big one.
That's what I don't think John Cena can deal with.
Rock trying to power out of this predicament.
I don't think anybody could, King. I don't think you could. I don't think I could.
Oof! Cena again.
No!
Cena, cover for the championship!
Rock landed hard, did some damage to that back.
I really think this early pace favors Cena.
I don't know. I mean, you may be right, Michael, but I don't think for 1 minute either one of these guys is in better shape or better condition than the other.
Neither one have opened. I agree with you, King. Neither one have opened up yet.
No.
They're both looking for an opportunity. They're
You're
both
exactly
looking not
right.
to make a mistake
exactly
so far.
Exactly right. I mean, John Cena came out and said it. He said, Rock, you didn't beat me. I beat me with a mistake.
Yeah, look at sleeper hold by The Rock. Sleeper hold. Cena trying to reverse. Yeah, but Rock has it locked in now. Cena's in the center of the ring.
Yeah, he does have it locked in.
Yeah, sleeper hold.
I thought Cena was able to turn and get turned to where a lot of that pressure would be off, but
yeah.
Rock's got it cinched in.
He's got it cinched in. He's got that 260-pound frame leaning on Cena. He's got to try to seem like a back to his feet, create some sort of separation.
Let's get inside of him just like that.
He does.
Oh. Cena's so strong. Picks Rock up with ease and just drops him flat.
Cover of the champion. That was a little statement by Cena there.
Cena looking out to the WWE Universe. Let's face it. You know, this crowd's split 50-50. Half for The Rock, half for John Cena.
These guys compete at everything. They compete on social media. They compete in movies. They compete in sports entertainment. And in some places, they're their only real viable competition is each other.
So with the elbow.
Oh, went for the elbow. Rock slips out of it quickly. Oh, and a Samoan drop. Be a critical point of this matchup.
I still agree with JBL wholeheartedly. Each one of these guys is just looking to, at this point, nobody's looking to win. They're just looking to not lose.
Fisherman,
right. Don't make a mistake.
By Cena, off the suplex, cover, hooks the leg on the champ who powers out at two.
I mean, I can win a match early, but you can lose one early sometimes.
You're exactly right. You know, in this case, The Rock, he can wrestle the entire match defensively. John Cena can't afford to do that. He's going to have to, as you said, he's going to have to open up.
Yeah, well, and Rock has champion's advantage, of course.
Right.
Cena needs to pin or make Rock submit to win the title.
Wow.
That's Rock exploding out of the corner. And there's Cena with a flying tackle. Nobody home, and these guys, again, know each other so well. And there's the Rock we know.
Yep, things are starting to open up here.
And now Cena is going for the STF.
Not too soon.
Rock went for the spine buster. Now Cena with a flying shoulder tackle. Rock right back to his feet. And this is, and what a
Rock. What a great counter.
Rock over the sharpshooter. Sharpshooter!
Oh, he's got
it's in! Sharpshooter! We'll see the tap out! Submission hold! And Cena, great counter.
That is strength.
Turn through there.
Cena rolls through.
That's not just a great counter, Michael. I agree. That's great strength.
Oh, and now Cena.
Here we go. Hey, Rock. You can't see me. Oh, nobody home for the five knuckle shuffle.
Now Rock plants Cena DDT. Oh,
with a quickness.
And Rock planted and ready.
Strength
of the Rock now. Shoulders down and forces Cena to break.
Oh, what's Cena got in mind here? Look out.
Oh, oh. Set off the top turnbuckle. Now it's Cena. Cena measuring the Rock.
Rock's reeling here.
Go for the AA. Whoa. AA time for Cena.
No.
Rock fighting out. Spine buster. Spine on the pine.
Oh, well, we saw the You Can't See Me and the five knuckle shuffle. Are we going to see the people?
Cena.
No, no, no.
Cena countered.
Rock took too long.
STF.
There's the STF, Michael.
Cena's got the STF in.
Cena's won championships with this. Is he gonna win another one tonight?
And look at the Rock's heel is almost gonna touch the back of his head.
And again, Rock trying to power out of this.
Look at this.
If he can break that grip, John Cena has on his head.
No one has powered out of the STF before. They broke it, they've gotten to the ropes. No one has just powered out of it like The Rock is about to do.
Look at this, he's broken the grip.
I can't believe this. Cena trying to lock it back in. Test of wills.
And The Rock's winning it.
Rock powered out of the STF.
Wow, Rock powers out of the STF, Cena kicks out of the rock bottom.
Whoa! Alex Cena with Rock up in the AA! Cena, cover for the championship! Rock powers out!
Both of these guys are a little woozy now. I think John Cena was playing a little possum, so to speak, there, just trying to lure Rock in.
Both these guys have taken their best shot at each other.
They have.
And neither one has worked. You better go back to well or find something new to do.
They've done some damage, though. Rock is stepping out of the ring to get a breather, or, oh no, he's going to the top. I mean, Cena.
It's destiny at stake. Swing for the fences, John.
John Cena with the legs
and he missed it. And he missed it.
And here's Rock, Spinebuster.
What's it gonna cost him?
Here we go. The most electrifying move in all of sports entertainment. The people do
it! Rock into the cover! Cena powers out!
Well, that's gonna do a little bit to the psyche of The Rock.
It's brilliant by Cena. Get out of the ring where you can't get pinned. 10-time WWE champion for a reason.
Yeah, but The Rock knows he just hit the people's elbow and it didn't get the job done.
And The Rock doesn't want to win by countout. Rock knows this is just about as much about history as John Cena does.
Oh yeah, The Rock's got a point. He's got a point to prove as well.
The Rock wants to go down as the greatest of all time. He knows this match can put him there. What a champion, wants to do it in the middle. Rock's feeling it.
I think Rock's thinking now about laying some smack down. It's John Cena.
Cena as well.
He's up to the task. Whoa.
Who's gonna win this one?
I love this. Check this out one more time. Oh, Rock ducks, thinks he's going for a cross body block, and he's caught by that muscle man, John Cena. But then Rock blocks the AA, delivers a rock bottom of his own, and still Cena survives.
Exactly, still he survives.
Fighting for redemption, guys, is a powerful force, and that's what John Cena believes he's fighting for.
The Rock and that connection that he has with the people, that's why he's the people's champion, as well as the WWE champion. Go for it one more time.
Oh, ho, ho, ho. Mocking it. Cena.
Cena caught it! Again!
Redemption! Oh. Redemption!
And oh. Two! Oh, I thought that was it. Oh, man. When I think about 79,900 here thought that was it.
Remember last year when Cena toyed with Rock? And that mistake cost Cena. It almost cost Rock right here.
It almost did, Michael, you're right. But look at Cena, he can't capitalize on it.
Going to be the first man to his feet here. A lot of punishment dished out in this match.
For the WWE Championship, Cena first back to his feet.
Trying to sucker the Rock in, and I thought he'd done it right there.
Cena learned from his mistakes.
But once again, the Rock able to counter with that rock bottom, but it still didn't get the job done.
These guys are throwing everything at each other. Now it's Cena again with the Rock up high. Rock countered another time. Rock, Cena.
Whoa.
Back
ropes,
and forth
ropes,
we
ropes,
go.
Nope. Rock is determined that he's going to hit that rock bottom for a win.
And Cena's determined he's going to hit the AA.
DDT. That might be enough right there. That might do it. Cover him. Boy, The Rock lying in wait.
These guys can't keep getting up.
This is an incredible moment.
John's got a feeling back there. He's got to know it. Nope.
And again, Cena counters. AA! Cover! Cena
got
does
him.
It!
He got him!
Achieves redemption.
A year in the making, Michael. Cena has thought about this for a year straight. Tonight, Cena got redemption. And a date with destiny.
John Cena has slain his personal demons. The Cena Nation.
And smile again.
The choices.
What a championship match.
No kidding.
John Cena has set a record tonight. 4 victories as a challenger in a world title match. And there it is, John. That's what it's all about. The WWE Championship.
What's this? I don't, you need a calculator to count how many AAs that was. But it finally did the trick. Once again, going for the Rock Bottom, but the Rock is caught in another AA. And this time, the championship changed hands.
Two great champions. The best of our generation.
By both of these men.
What a WrestleMania, huh? Man.
That's respect. That's what's good about our business. Electrifying.
the widow of the late great Arnold Skull, and of course The Rock's mom, his daughter, all in attendance here tonight.
Well done, Rock. Well done. What a great champion, The Rock.
Let's first talk about the challenger, Rhea Ripley. What does she need to do to finally knock off Charlotte Flair and win the SmackDown Women's Championship?
Rhea Ripley may be one of, if not the only female superstar in WWE who can overpower Charlotte Flair. Charlotte relies so heavily on her power game, but I don't think she'll be much of a match for the strength of the Eradicator.
Okay, with that said, what does Charlotte have to do then to change up her game to keep the title?
Charlotte needs to rely on her experience. Charlotte has been here before. She is no stranger to the bright lights of WrestleMania. This is what Charlotte exists for. She just simply needs to do what she does as the queen.
And you saw the look on Rhea's face, almost trying to play some mind games, some psychological warfare, but I don't think that will work on Charlotte.
I agree, and it all comes back to the familiarity. These two have faced off in the past. This is not the same Rhea Ripley that Charlotte Flair remembers, so Charlotte knows she had to strategize differently. With that said, there's a certain amount of confidence that comes with earning a victory over any opponent at WrestleMania. That's going to benefit Charlotte in this one.
I mentioned it earlier, the fact that Rhea Ripley understands the importance of this moment, that this is a star-making moment for her. The fact that it's WrestleMania, it's Hollywood, it's Los Angeles, it's Charlotte Flair.
Charlotte Flair paintbrushing the back of Rhea's neck.
But the thing I've noticed about Rhea in recent months, Corey, is the fact that she has never seemed as confident as she has now.
I agree. There's the power we were talking about. Ripley taking the champion down, and I think the power advantage is what's helping the confidence of the challenger.
Charlotte went for the hip toss.
Rhea's grown incredibly confident recently. Not to mention her alignment with the
Judgment Day. Shoulder tackle by Charlotte.
You can't be around a group of people as talented as Balor and Priest, and even dating back to Edge as the Judgment Day, and not pick up a few tricks along the way. That has all helped Rhea grow into a different superstar. She's truly evolved.
Charlotte, a 14-time champion. She's won the Royal Rumble. She's won a tag team title.
And I asked Rhea about that fact, and what Rhea said to me is that shows that the queen can be beaten.
Gotcha. Huh? You think you're the queen, huh? You think you're the queen? I am.
Oh, what a chop. Rhea, though, gonna power Charlotte into the corner.
Rhea just bulldozing the champion.
Well, it's not often, as you mentioned, at the top of this match, Corey, that happens in a Charlotte Flair match.
Charlotte answers with a hellacious right hand and another to the challenger. Tremendous athleticism possessed by
Bo, and a boot right to the face drops Rhea. You see Charlotte nodding with confidence. Massive crowd here tonight, over 75,000 at SoFi in Los Angeles. Cross body.
Fantastic. Cross body by the champion. But Rhea answers with an elbow on the ear.
Yeah, this is going to be a very physical matchup.
I talked about the evolution of Rhea Ripley, but Charlotte Flair, to her credit, is also a champion who's never stagnated, always adding new wrinkles and techniques to her game, spending a great deal of time in Mexico and around the world honing her skills and learning new tricks.
Oh! Charlotte off the top turnbuckle, and Rhea's got an opportunity now.
But even Flair didn't have an answer to the power of Ripley there.
Rhea shaking off the early assault from Charlotte.
Every one of these stomps from Rhea Ripley is agonizing. The challenger just overwhelming the champion right now.
And it's been such an interesting build to this match because
oh my goodness! So hard to pick a winner, a favorite coming into this. Oh, and Charlotte driven face first.
And Rhea beginning to show her dominance.
Take a look at the power of the challenger as Charlotte launched face first into the turnbuckle. The cover there from Ripley, not enough to put away the champion just yet.
Yeah, a little psychological battle though there, telling Charlotte, listen, had an opportunity to get you down.
Face first goes Flair.
Charlotte Flair possesses such a unique quality as a superstar that the deeper in trouble Charlotte finds herself, the harder she fights. It's almost as though the more punishment you inflict on Charlotte Flair, the more punishment she throws back your way.
Rhea's inflicting a tremendous amount of punishment on Charlotte right now.
Ripley utilizing her powerful legs to just squeeze the breath out of Charlotte Flair with this body lock. This is a great position for the challenger to be in because it allows her to strategize. She's not in any real danger, but she's simultaneously wearing down Charlotte Flair.
But again, let's not forget that the champion has the advantage in this match. Rhea has to submit or pin Charlotte to win the championship.
Absolutely, but Rhea knows that with the experience that Charlotte Flair possesses, Rhea cannot afford to make mistakes. One mistake could cost Ripley the biggest opportunity of her career. Here comes Charlotte.
Creates some separation. Back to her feet. Big bow, roll up now. Is it enough to put her away? And a kick of two. Ooh.
Ooh, and again.
Forearm echoing throughout SoFi
Stadium. Third time, this one drops Charlotte to her knees. This is the pace Rhea wants. Oh, this went for a fourth, and Charlotte was able to counter.
Rhea got greedy, went to the well one time too many, but
German suplex released. Quickly into the cover of the champion to try to win the title, and Charlotte has to kick out. And Charlotte landed hard on the back of her neck. Over 75,000 tonight. WrestleMania Saturday, SoFi Stadium, Los Angeles, California. This match for the SmackDown Women's Championship, Charlotte Flair defending against the winner of the 2023 Royal Rumble match, Rhea Ripley.
How much does this championship mean to you?
Huh? What Rhea Ripley's attempting to do by talking so much trash is break the champion's spirit. Get under the skin of the queen. Much easier said than done.
Oh, and again.
Ripley's got so much poise right now. Delivering her offense, not in any rush, not in any hurry, but Charlotte delivers a spinning back elbow. I'm not sure how much of it she got, but it appears to be enough for the moment to buy the queen some time.
A tremendous fight in Charlotte. And right there, vintage Charlotte as she bounces Rhea face first off the top turnbuckle. And now Charlotte has turned this match around. She knows she's got Rhea Ripley where she wants her.
Very briefly, a smile washed across the face of the champion. Charlotte knows this is where she wants to be. The queen smells blood. Oof. Big chop.
Oh, you like that?
And each one of these knife-edge chops from Charlotte Flair sending shockwaves of pain through Ripley's body.
Rhea buckling in pain. And now Charlotte begins to dissect the legs, which will set up the figure eight, the submission move that Charlotte has put away so many people.
For all intents and purposes, this could be the beginning of the end for Rhea Ripley. The queen looking to systematically destroy her challenger, as she's done so many times in the past. Big right rocks Rhea.
Charlotte showing confidence, taking over. Rhea misses wildly a couple of times. Charlotte Flair has it at her pace now.
Charlotte trying to amp herself up with a little help from the WWE Universe here in Los Angeles.
Charlotte top rope. Rhea rolls through, powering Charlotte up.
The queen still fighting, even a... Rhea thinking about Riptide.
Charlotte countered into a DDT. What a move for the win. Hooks the leg. Rhea kicks it too.
My God. What a counter by Charlotte Flair. A DDT that spiked Ripley on the crown of her skull, and somehow the challenger survived.
Does some self-doubt start to creep in for the champ now?
Not yet. I truly don't believe that even at this point, Charlotte is going to get truly frustrated. Maybe slightly. Maybe she expected to have this won by now, but here we go, looking for the figure four.
And Rhea Ripley able to kick out. Charlotte, though, rolls. Oh, Rhea kicks again.
Rhea caught the queen right on the chin with a boot. Inside cradle.
One, two.
Not a no, almost had her. Charlotte. Now both women down center of the ring. Critical moment in this match.
Both women with the same idea. Both connecting with big boots.
Rhea trying to get herself back into this matchup. As a sold out WWE Universe looks on at SoFi Stadium in Los Angeles. WrestleMania Saturday, we're gonna be sold out tomorrow night as well. This is for the SmackDown Women's Championship. Charlotte Flair, the champion. Rhea Ripley, the challenger. It is an incredible atmosphere inside this stadium. A buzz and electricity. Rhea Ripley stopped to the foot. Ooh, face first off the knee.
A great counter by the queen.
And now Charlotte, great throw.
Charlotte Flair flexing a little power of her own. But was that Charlotte's last gasp? She hasn't moved since delivering.
The classic Charlotte kip up.
The queen is realizing where she is. This is the showcase of immortals. This is WrestleMania. This is what Charlotte Flair lives for, where she exists.
Rubbing a little salt in the wound, a little insult to injury as Charlotte now goes up to the top rope. Rhea Ripley back to her feet. Gonna meet Charlotte there.
Uh-oh. Precarious position for both women.
Charlotte able to fight out. Rhea back. Oh my God!
That's gotta do it!
New champion!
New champion!
Charlotte still in the match! How the hell did Charlotte kick out?
I have no earthly idea, nor does Rhea Ripley, who may have just fired her best shot.
How did Charlotte Flair, she not smash her face?
I mean, Charlotte Flair did, landing face first In the center of the ring, Rhea took quite a nasty fall herself. And that slight delay before executing the cover may be the only reason Charlotte's still in this match. Rhea scrambled with everything in her being.
Meanwhile, Charlotte goes to the back of the knee. The chop block by Charlotte. Now natural selection. Charlotte now to try to retain. Is it enough to keep the championship? Rhea Ripley at 2.5.
Rhea slid out the back door and wisely rolling under the bottom rope. I understand champion's advantage. Rhea wants to keep this in the ring, but in this moment, after just suffering that flurry from the Queen, it's a smart move to roll out and try to regain composure.
Corey, what a match for the SmackDown Women's Championship. One of the all-time great Charlotte Flair. Rhea Ripley, the challenger, wants to get at that level, but she has to beat Charlotte to do that.
It's proven to be an impossible task for so many. Charlotte stalking Rhea.
And Rhea sidestepped and Charlotte went into the steps.
Full speed, shoulder first. The Queen may have separated her shoulder or worse.
And Ripley quickly back into the ring. Realizes she has an opportunity. With Charlotte up, Charlotte down face first. Rhea cover to win the championship here tonight at WrestleMania. And again a kick out.
And Rhea, in the heat of the moment, didn't pin both of Charlotte's shoulders down. We see this impact with the ring stairs. Ripley would drive the Queen down face first. But look at the cover. Charlotte Flair's left shoulder was not pinned down, which may be the only reason this match still rolls on.
Rhea looking for Riptide to win the championship. Charlotte from behind.
German suplex.
Rhea somehow making it back to her feet. Trying to hang on. Charlotte again.
Rough landing on the shoulder of Rhea Ripley and the Queen maintaining the waist lock.
Well, it just shows you the amount of punishment that this match is taking its toll on both of these women. Standing switch by Rhea. And now it's Ripley's turn. Oh my God!
Yikes. That was nearly catastrophic for Charlotte Flair. This is a golden opportunity, quite literally, for Rhea Ripley. Look at this. Charlotte Flair, I mean, face first, literally.
I can't believe
Charlotte's still fighting after that.
No idea. I have no idea how Charlotte Flair still functions in this matchup. Big kick. The boot by Charlotte. Cover to retain. Rhea gets the shoulder up.
Wow.
Another near fall.
You can see the brush burn on Charlotte's nose from the German suplex as we look back again at the boot that nearly ended this in favor of Flair. But Rhea showing some tenacity of her own.
What an incredible battle for the SmackDown Women's Championship. Charlotte looking for the figure four. Rhea trying to counter again. Charlotte's not been able to lock it in this entire match.
Let's take a look once more. Just look closely at the impact. Literally, Charlotte Flair's face landing before the rest of her body. No mitigation whatsoever of that impact.
Now Charlotte with a boot drops Rhea to the floor.
But you can never count out the Queen. We are, as you like to say, Cole, in the deep waters of this matchup, and it's still too close to call.
Yeah, but in the deep waters of this matchup is where Charlotte Flair rises to the top, and that's what she's going to do now. She's going to go up top. If there's a move that's defined Charlotte throughout her career, you're looking at it. From the top rope, moonsault, down goes Ripley.
Flair got all of it.
Now the Queen needs to get Rhea back in the ring and finish the job.
Charlotte takes down Rhea, and again Rhea counters. Went for the spear. Almost took out referee Jessica Carr. Ripley with a headbutt. Ripley! Riptide! Cover!
Charlotte kicked out! Ripley's beside herself!
$75,000 are beside themselves. Watch the look on Rhea's face when Charlotte kicked out.
Complete disbelief. Rhea has used that maneuver to put away countless opponents. But not tonight, not the Queen.
Now is Rhea frustrated? Trying to drag Charlotte. Slamming her face down to the mat.
Oh,
Charlotte roll up to retain. Two. Rhea kicked at it at 2.5.
Just barely. Ripley now looking to cinch in the prism lock submission.
A version of the cloverleaf locked in here on Charlotte Flair.
Charlotte utilizing her long arms. She's still got her hands on the ground. This is going to minimize the pain a little bit.
Yeah, but Charlotte's got to set out, try to make it to a rope to break. If she taps, Rhea's the champion. Charlotte trying to drag herself to the bottom rope to force a break. Is this Ripley's moment? Is Rhea Ripley going to tap out the 14-time champion?
Charlotte scratching, clawing to the corner, and the champion's made it to the ropes.
And Rhea's got 5 to break, and now Rhea driven into the official.
Just a incidental contact
there. Cover from out of nowhere. Rhea kicks again. You gotta be kidding me. Look at the face of Charlotte. The look of what do I need to do? What the hell do I need to do?
Charlotte Flair. Not a superstar who ever shows doubt.
Or emotion like this.
That is the face of a champion who is doubting herself.
Charlotte needs to dig down deep.
You want my place? You want me? Come on. Come on. Come on.
Back and forth, champion and challenger.
This is incredible. Charlotte and Rhea exchanging blows. There's a kick from Rhea. Charlotte with a kick of her own. The challenger's down.
Here we go.
Charlotte now.
Figure four.
Can she bridge? Can she bridge to the figure eight?
Ripley got the bottom rope.
Great ring presence by Ripley.
Charlotte Flair, the proud champion, did not want to get herself disqualified. Flair wants to leave Los Angeles with there being no doubt in anyone's mind.
This is one of the most incredible championship matches you'll ever witness at WrestleMania.
Or any other day of the year for that matter. This is absolutely epic. These two women leaving it all in the ring for the right to be the SmackDown Women's Champion.
Rhea bounced off the ring post. Charlotte out of the second rope, trying to drag Rhea up. Charlotte Flair, what's she gonna try to do up there?
Oh my, oh my, this will not end well.
Dangerous situation for champion and challenger. No one willing. Oh, and Charlotte! Face first off the post, she may be out.
I think she is. Charlotte Flair's body just went limp.
Charlotte may be out cold.
The Queen
basically melted on the top turnbuckle.
Rhea screaming in the face of the champion, it's my time! And it might be! Riptide! Cover! Rhea Ripley's the SmackDown Women's Champion!
Here is your winner!
Sit out here for 26 years. That is one of the damnedest, the most physical, the most incredible championship matches I've ever witnessed.
I'll agree and do you one better. That's one of the best matches I've ever witnessed. Period, bar none. Congratulations to the Eradicator.
Rhea Ripley, what a star-making moment.
But it did not come easy. The queen threw it all at her challenger, soaring through the sky in SoFi Stadium. But here's what turned everything around. The closing moments, Charlotte Flair connecting with the top of the ring post, an avalanche-style Eradicator.
And I want you to watch this, Corey, because in Rhea Ripley's homeland of Australia, it's about 1 o'clock Sunday afternoon.
One, two, three.
And that was what happened when Rhea Ripley knocked off the queen. Charlotte Flair is one of the greatest champions in the history of WWE.
And Charlotte has no reason whatsoever to hang her head because the queen went out on her Shield tonight.
But even Charlotte Flair pointed back to Rhea Ripley and said, you earned it tonight because it is the Eradicator's time. The landscape of SmackDown is changed forever because Rhea Ripley is in charge.
I choose you, Roman Reigns.
We're gonna take it to a whole new level.
Oh, we run the wall.
When it gets this personal, no holds bars is the only way to go about it.
Triple H, Batista, match underway, no holds barred. Remember, if
Triple H loses,
he must retire from in-ring competition. Will this be the final night we see Triple H in the ring? And again, fighting back now with right hands to the animal, Batista. And Batista, a clubbing blow, takes out the game.
Already getting physical.
Not to mention Triple H recovering from the torn pectoral muscle. But Triple H, now he wears many hats here in WWE. He's had WrestleMania week since last week. He's been going seven strong days, training in the ring, business meetings outside of it. How's that going to affect his matchup with the Animal tonight?
And here comes Triple H making his way out here in front of the announce table. Batista falling hard out of the ring in the game. He's sent right over the announce table and almost into the lap of his longtime friend, Shawn Michaels.
Here we go, and it's already getting ugly.
And Triple H now on the
can't say
table.
We're surprised. Oh, God.
And tackling Batista and unloading with the right hands.
Batista hit the side of the ring incredibly hard with his right shoulder.
And look at the strength of Batista. And that's what Triple H has to contend with tonight, the power of the Animal.
And this is one of the first times, like, you have to understand, as strong as Triple H is, Dave is one of the most powerful guys that WWE has ever seen.
Oh, Triple H! And was that a toolbox? Not the first time we've seen that used in the rivalry between these two men. No holds barred, anything goes, completely legal here tonight.
And I'm going to tell you what, I know Dave's had success in Hollywood, but I know they don't work like that out there.
I think anybody does, Sean. And now Triple H with the chain in hand.
Oh, no, 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 no.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
my God, are you kidding me?
Jeez.
The anger, the disgust from Triple H comes to the fact that this man, Batista, beat up a 70-year-old Hall of Famer. Oh, my God. A legend, Ric Flair, on his birthday. Sean, a man that you have respected your entire career. And to see Batista do that, Triple H wants to punish this man.
Well, see, that's the thing. I mean, everything, he is calm in every aspect of his life, but he loves his friends.
This is absolutely nasty.
Oh!
Got that chain wrapped around the face and the skull of Batista. Triple H planning to end this early. He's writhing in pain.
It's gotta be agonizing.
That can't help his movie career for sure.
Well, look out, look out, look out. Batista, oh, shoulder first into the steps. Triple H wants to maim the animal.
I gotta tell you, man, I've been friends with him so long, I forgot how freaking mean he is.
Well, you've had a tremendous rivalry.
I know, but
Triple
you get
H,
away from
Sean.
Him as long as I have, you get a little soft, and I got news for you. He is your one bad son of a gun.
What the heck is he?
Oh, he's got channel locks.
Again, completely legal.
Oh, what?
No holds barred.
Little of the sadistic side of him you don't see too much.
Well, you're seeing it here tonight.
Oh, no, no, no. This is too far. No, don't, no, 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 no.
Break his fingers. Oh, my God. He's trying to break his hand.
Triple H is maiming Batista.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, God. It's safe to say, but Batista's got to be regretting this.
Oh,
oh God!
That broke his fingers. That had to break his fingers.
Well, I mean, I guess I understand. Triple H's career is on the line. He'll stop at nothing to protect it, but. What? This is just like a casual.
Yeah, unbiased commentary, Sean, nonetheless. Now,
not needle nose. No. No.
Oh my God. Triple H is sadistic as they come. Batista wanted this. He asked for this.
What?
He drove Triple H.
Oh,
to
I know where this is going. Oh, that hurts. God.
What's he going to do now? Pull Batista's teeth out of his head?
Oh. I've been on the receiving end of one of those, and it does not feel good.
Batista said Triple H's biggest mistake is that the game underestimated Batista.
Oh, my God. I was being facetious. This. No.
He's going after the fingers again. Here we go. He's going to get his other fingers.
A smile. A sick smile.
That's a nice nose ring.
No.
Hold on.
Don't you dare.
Going after the nose.
Batista's helpless. He's pinned under the chair.
Oh,
no. No. He's got it.
He's
got a swing out of his nose.
That's got to hurt, though.
Oh,
my goodness. He got it. Oh, you kids, you shouldn't get your body pierced like that.
Oh, my.
Corey Graves, that could hurt. I think.
Of course it could hurt. That's Triple H is maiming Batista's face.
Oh, look, there it is.
He's going to be able to be Guardian of the Galaxy after this. He's going to be able to guard his own freaking house. This is.
Guys, Triple H.
This is
just
sick.
A nose ring out of the nose of Batista.
This guy's my boss.
That's what I'm saying.
Look at it, look at it.
That's what I'm saying. In everyday life, again, he wears that corporate VP thing. I mean, pretty rationally during the day, but man, that is my buddy from all those years ago. He is still 1-6, son of a gun. Oh, look at Dave. Oh, his nose is bleeding.
You think?
I mean, his fingers may be broken.
Oh, his casting agent.
Now his skull's
going to
get caved in.
Oh, Triple H caught by the animal and dropped right on our announce table. Triple H came off the apron with a chain wrapped around his hand, and Batista was able to counter and then drop Triple H spine first right off our table.
Batista bought himself a valuable few seconds, but will he be able to capitalize?
Oh, no.
Well, they made their way to our right, our Spanish announce table. Once again, Triple H driven on top of the table.
Oh. And that's the problem. You don't put Dave away early, man. He's going to come after you.
I can't believe Batista's still moving forward. I mean, his fingers are mangled. His nose is bleeding.
Look, we didn't just call him the animal because we thought it was a nifty, cool name.
Remember, Batista was handpicked by Triple H. Triple H ran into the barricade. Triple H, in many ways, the mentor for Batista. One of the reasons Batista reached the heights he did in his career.
Well, that's how all this started, Cole. Look, you don't leave on your own terms. I don't care how much success you have in other lines of work, even Hollywood.
And again, the game dropped on the announce table.
A sickening thud.
Well, this was earlier on. Watch this. This is the ripping the nose ring out of the face of Batista.
Well, amateur plastic surgery courtesy of the game.
One of the sickest things I've seen. And then holding it like a trophy.
And that's why Batista's here, and that's why he's trying to end Triple H's career. He wants to finish on his terms. And he feel like he didn't get to do that because of Triple H.
Well, he quit, John. There's something to cut to the chase. Batista quit. He can say whatever he wants about Triple H, but he quit. And now Triple H went into the barricade again.
Yeah, but in his defense, Cole, Batista quit for good reasons. It's not like he went to Hollywood and failed. The guy's a major movie star these days.
Dude, I get that. And look, you could say he quit. He did, all right? But I got news for you. You don't leave on your terms, it haunts you for the rest of your life. Again, he can have all the success he wants in Hollywood, but until he gets to walk away from the WWE his way, he is not going to be happy. And I got news for you, ending Triple H's career is the only way he wants to leave here.
Well, looks like he's getting a little bit closer to accomplishing his goal because the game is in a bad way all of a sudden. Cover here by Batista.
Batista, middle of the ring, hook of the leg, and Triple H gets the shoulder up at two. Remember, if Triple H loses, his in-ring career is over. Critical time here for the game.
Batista once again attacking the midsection of Triple H.
And say what you want, all that time away, Big Dave taking all that punishment early, but he's still got some steam left. Oh!
You're absolutely right.
There's an example of it right there, Sean. Cover again. Will Triple H's in-ring career be over? And a two count.
Might have taken him a second to get out of the gate, but to this point, Batista has shown almost no signs of ring rust whatsoever.
I mean, he had to have nerves. Believe me, he hadn't been in the ring since 2014.
But again, that's the thing. I mean, we all believed in Dave. He was good, six-time world champion. But again, it doesn't matter. He's the one that's got to believe. And until he beats that guy he's in the ring with, he's not going to believe it.
Triple H, knee off the face of Batista. And Triple H looks to gain some momentum and climb back into this match. Nobody home, into the post goes Batista, shoulder first.
Triple H buys himself a few moments to try to recover from the damage inflicted by the animal, but here comes Batista once again.
Looking for the pedigree.
Putting him away.
Middle of the ring, Batista. Looking to counter.
Batista crashes down.
This could be it. It could be over. I don't know. Almost had him near fall. I think Batista's beginning to remember what Triple H is all about. And the guts in the game. And the metal that Triple H is made of.
And Sean, this deep into a match, this big, of this magnitude at WrestleMania, how much does adrenaline play a part?
Well, again, you know what I was just thinking? It's like, I wonder, this is the point where, again, you come in there, it's WrestleMania, you're ready to go, you're hyped up. And then everything, you get the adrenaline dump, and then the reality of your career being on the line begins to sink in. Every punch, every pinfall, everything is heightened.
Oh my God, Batista with steel steps. Steel steps in hand.
Bad intentions.
Right off the face of Triple H.
Oh, what? Triple H, or I'm sorry, Batista trying to get the feeling back in his fingertips. What is he doing now? It's no holds barred, anything goes.
Come on, Dave.
Well, it appears Batista strategically put those steps on the Spanish announce table.
Come on, Dave. Animal doing a little redecorating here at ringside.
And he just pointed right at Shawn Michaels.
The Animal's on a rampage right now. This does not bode well for Triple H. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh,
God. What the hell is he thinking?
You can see he's thinking something.
Batista surveying the scene and maybe weighing his options. No.
Here we go.
No.
Guys, he's looking down at our table.
Yep.
Oh my God, he's calling for it. Batista's calling for it. The Batista bomb that's put away so many opponents over the years.
Well, it's going to end Triple H's career.
Oh my God, back body drop right onto our table.
Triple H just averted disaster. It might have broken Batista's back. And the game just preserved his career a little longer.
After everything they've been through, Big Dave on the announce table.
Just spine jarring impact.
Batista's barely moved. Triple H has barely moved again. Batista crashing down on this table.
This has become a war of attrition right now.
Triple H battling for his career.
Both men struggling to get to their feet.
Batista battling to end the game's historic run in WWE.
Batista miraculously back up to his feet again, but so is the game.
And Triple H!
Oh,
the table!
Oh my God!
The DX crotch chop! And then Triple H driving Batista through the Spanish, through the German table, and both men are down.
And it's Triple H that doses out the spear on Dave Batista right through the announce table.
These two men are going to destroy one another. The carnage just increasing by the minute. Triple H driving the Animal through a table.
And
here
no countout, no double disqualification.
Triple H doing everything he can to preserve his in-ring career. And to Sean's point, this is no holds barred. Anything goes. You have to win via pinfall or submission.
One man gets to leave with peace in his heart. The other one, a career is over.
At this point, I think someone's about to leave in pieces, Sean. This is ridiculous. Batista's trying to make his way back to his feet, but
I don't know if the Animal will ever have peace. Maybe a little closure is the best we can hope for.
The Animal now clutching on the game's feet, preventing Hunter from getting back in the ring.
Oh, just
and
a
Look at Batista
right
hammering away at Triple H. We've talked so much about ring rust and about Batista being in shape, and we mentioned this at the top of the match, guys. The fact that Triple H is returning to the in-ring action tonight for the first time since tearing his pec back late last year.
You know, pectoral muscle is an incredibly difficult injury to heal from. It's a testament to Triple H's physical toughness that he made it and recovered to this point. But
gentlemen, after 30 years, I have watched him come back from every injury under God's green earth. That doesn't surprise me. And this war of attrition doesn't surprise. Oh, boy.
God only knows what Triple H is looking for under the ring. We've already seen a toolbox come into play, needle nose pliers.
There's only one other best friend I know of.
Steel steps, announce tables.
Yeah.
Old Faithful.
But he wouldn't be the game without the sledgehammer.
After everything he's put the animal through and still hasn't been able to close the deal, desperate times call for desperate measures. And of course, anything goes. Here we go.
Oh, spear by Batista.
Spear by Dave.
There's the cover. The
That's
game's
it.
Career
Run
is
on.
Over.
Run
almost on. Had him. Near fall for the animal.
Batista was less than a half a second away from ending Triple H's career here at WrestleMania.
The sledgehammer went flying. Batista hit him with a spear and almost ended the career.
Take another look at this. Triple H looking to use the sledgehammer, but Batista beat him to the punch in the form of a spear that nearly cut the game in half.
Oh no.
Oh no.
And now Batista. Batista has the sledgehammer. And Batista, look at and Triple H fighting back. Boot to the face. And now the game has his hands on his weapon of choice. And Batista again averting disaster. Uh-oh, Spinebuster!
The animal is still just that, the animal.
How many times have we witnessed this scene over the years? The stomping of the feet at the ropes.
Batista looking for the Batista bomb. This is going to be the final chapter for Triple H's career.
And he connects!
Batista bomb!
Can Batista put away the game?
That's it! That's it!
In ending the Hall of Fame career of Triple H, but it's still intact. He kicks it two off the Batista bomb.
Batista able to hoist the game up. You can see the intention of Triple H to use the sledgehammer, maybe prevent Batista from finishing the maneuver, but no success. It's amazing that the game is still in this.
Well, it's amazing the amount of effort from these two superstar athletes in this match here tonight. No holds barred at WrestleMania. One hoping to end the career of the other.
And what is the animal gonna dream up next? Back to the steel ring stairs once again. This will not end well, no matter what Batista has in mind.
Triple H has barely moved since the Batista bomb by the animal.
Just when you thought this thing couldn't get any more brutal, any more physical,
any more personal. That's what this is, Sean. It's personal for both of these men. Batista feels like Triple H held him down for so many years in his career. He said he quit to get away from the game. And now he wants to end the game's in-ring career.
Batista feels that the game used him. The Triple H benefited from Batista's existence within WWE, and it wasn't fair. He's not happy about it.
You know what, being so far removed now, but I do remember. You know what, you gotta understand, you're with each other every day, you compete. There are egos in this, and sometimes they just clash, and you gotta know, am I better than you? Am I better than you?
Well, we're gonna find out.
Big Dave's gotta know.
Right here, with Batista looking back to the steps. Triple H, though, manages to slip underneath.
No way. Oh, no, there's no way. Dave will never survive this. Oh, God. Oh, my God.
Right out of the steps.
Oh, oh, and he's up. Oh, it's the pedigree. Oh,
Batista.
That's it. That's it. Here we go.
Oh,
my God. Unbelievable.
Are you kidding me?
How in the hell did that happen? How did Batista survive this brutal powerbomb onto the steel stairs? How did Batista manage to get back to any sort of base to suffer a pedigree, let alone survive it?
And then how was he able to kick out?
That's just unbelievable.
If there was ever any doubt that the man known as the Animal lived up to his moniker in this business, that doubt was just removed.
I don't know how that doesn't sap any ounce of hope.
I can't believe Batista is still moving.
Freaking unbelievable.
Yeah, to your point, Sean, Triple H, what does he do?
How do you come? They're just, you, I have never not believed in my friend, but I...
Sean, I mean, you know,
seriously,
Triple H, is he doubting himself right now?
How do you not, man? That is...
Looking to use the sledgehammer yet again, but Batista intercepted him and a DDT right onto the steps.
Batista delivered that DDT with such speed and such impact, Triple H was completely vertical on top of the stairs.
Can you
look at this one more time?
I just cannot believe. Watch this impact. Bang! I cannot believe what these two athletes are putting themselves through. Batista hasn't been in a ring in 5 years. Triple H hasn't been a full-time performer in at least that long. And now this here tonight.
The physical toll that this has taken on their bodies is unbelievable. What they have put themselves through. Dave can't even stand. Look at that.
Sean, I think it's safe to say neither one of these individuals will be the same again after tonight.
You can't. There's no way. You absolutely do not. Oh.
Well, but I got it. Look at
that. Oh, my goodness.
The Nature Boy, Ric Flair, Triple H's mentor, the man who Batista attacked.
And Ric Flair just hand-delivered the sledgehammer to Triple H.
Stay away from Rick. They were like family. At one time, Evolution.
And the Kingdom with a sledgehammer launching himself off the steps. And as Ric Flair looks on, Triple H with a pedigree. The Game vanquishes the Animal.
Here is your winner, The Game.
About to enter the ring, weighing 300
is a psychotic, hideous monster is that man Kane. He thrives on pain. He lives on misery. And there's no doubt that he has evil intentions in destroying his own flesh and blood here tonight.
Wow.
Dangerously evil is Kane.
He doesn't look like he's been intimidated.
Uh-oh.
Experience sitting here in the Garden at WrestleMania 20 and just experiencing the arrival, the return of the dead man. And Kane is obviously beside himself. This is not what Kane wanted to see.
No, the dead man lives. He lives, JR.
The dead man and Paul Bearer live. And remember, The Undertaker has never lost. At WrestleMania, he's 11-0.
Kane still can't believe it.
tell a story from both men. And this huge crowd here in Madison Square Garden, beginning with the Undertaker chant. The intensity here is absolutely unbelievable, and Kane has got to muster every ounce and every fiber of his being, every ounce of intensity that he can create here.
I hope you don't think that you're going to try to get Kane to focus on something or rationalize something. This man, Kane, this monster, is messed up in the head, JR, and that's going to be a bad thing for The Undertaker. Look at him. His mind is twisted. He's distorted. He still can't believe that The Undertaker is standing within arm's reach of him. He doesn't believe it's real.
No. Oh, The Undertaker is real. He's in the right hands by the dead man. And look at The Undertaker upstairs, downstairs, hammering the 330-pound younger brother, humbling Kane.
Look out. The referee running for his life.
And who could blame him? The Undertaker sending Kane now for the ride. And Kane making a U-turn. Malfunction of jumps for Kane. Get the hell out of the ring. Undertaker is going right after Kane. Undertaker not left. Oh, Kane catching Undertaker with a big right hand. And now Kane trying to become and is becoming the aggressor in this one-on-one match.
As I said, JR, Kane is twisted. You never know what he's on. Look out!
Kane's ribs ramming into the apron, that edge of the ring. Undertaker front face knocking and taking Kane back into the ring. The dead man has returned at WrestleMania. Across the elbow, aggressively and violently into the throat of his brother Kane. Undertaker moving around here very, very, very well.
Undertaker, oh my gosh!
Stolen leg drop! Classic Undertaker offense.
It appears that The Undertaker would love to bury his brother Kane when this match is over.
Undertaker,
that referee, I'd stay well out of the way of both of these individuals.
Kane reeling back in that corner. Undertaker sends Kane for the ride, and that is a big ride for a big man. And Undertaker, full head of steam, the dead man wants to put an exclamation point. This match with more high impact, high intensity offense. And The Undertaker representing SmackDown, Kane representing Raw.
That six sadistic Paul Bearer. Oh no.
Undertaker, look at him.
Oh, look out.
Kane elevating The Undertaker. Undertaker
tried to grab those ropes to stop his fall, but he was only partially successful.
Undertaker tried to protect himself, but couldn't from that kick by Kane. And Kane, what a ravaged dog, like a shark tasting blood. He's right in The Undertaker's face, hammering with those right hands.
Just choked.
Right hand by Kane.
I told you not to come back.
Undertaker countering Kane. Kane trying to cover up, but Undertaker getting those big right hands in. The referee, I can't blame the referee for being intimidated. And sidewalk slam by Kane, taking down The Undertaker with so much power, so much strength, and now Kane must feel so desperate here. He's taking a chance. Kane going up to the top turnbuckle.
Desperation is not what The Undertaker's about to feel. He's about to feel the wrath of Kane.
That could do it right there. That could do it right there. The clothesline off the top, the cover, the count, and Undertaker kicks out.
That Paul Bearer with that arm.
Undertaker inside. Excuse me, King. Undertaker right back up. Scored with a right hand. Big overhand right. I hope these men and another. Neither going down, willing themselves vertically. And another right hand by an uppercut that really, really found its mark on the dead man by Kane. Nobody there. Oh my God! A runaway train. Undertaker almost taking Kane's head off. And a leg drop.
That should do it right there.
No, no, Kane already up. Great elevation by the Undertaker, but Kane, you got to hand him, the psychotic freak is absolutely, he's got his high threshold of pain, seemingly as his own brother.
Wait a minute, this crowd senses it. It's the dead man walking, I'm afraid, JR.
And in this crowd, rising to their feet, for Vintage Undertaker, walking the top rope. And
oh my God!
Kane counter! Kane counter his brother!
Have you ever seen that before?
Absolutely not!
The Undertaker jumping off that top rope right into the grip, that vice grip of his brother Kane. Now look at this!
Undertaker retaliates, grabbing the throat of his brother. Brother versus brother. And the death grips of now the Undertaker. With the advantage, trying to go for the touchdown. But Kane, in desperation, with a great sense of urgency counter. And now Kane.
Look!
Chokeslam. What a chokeslam by Kane on his
Kane has got it. Kane has got the Undertaker, Jared. Look at that.
Kane laughing in disgust. It's disgusting to me to watch him to laugh in this manner. He's just chokeslammed his brother to hell, has Kane.
In this crowd, nobody thought this was possible. The return of the dead man, and look, he's dead again.
But it's a chokeslam. Undertaker just set up! Oh no! Undertaker set up, and Kane cannot believe what he has seen. It's no mirage. It is your worst nightmare, to say the least. Oh! Firing back, dip right hand. Wow.
There's no effect, Kane, what are you gonna do?
That big kick had no effect to the Undertaker. The dead man now. Oh, ducking the clothesline.
Oh!
Going up in the air, striking Kane in the face.
Almost
with that,
took Kane's head off.
With that clothesline, and now the Undertaker signifying that the end could be near.
We got Kane!
Undertaker.
Oh!
Kane. A huge man, 300 plus, just got chokeslam. And now the Undertaker. Look at that face. Look at the eyes.
Come on, Kane. I'm expecting Kane to sit up. Oh, no.
Kane trying to crawl up. And
there's no mercy in that face. No mercy from the Undertaker. Kane, you're gonna have to pull this out yourself somehow.
Undertaker, is it gonna? It could be time out of the brother! And it's a tombstone driver! A tombstone pile driver on Kane, who can now rest in peace!
Here is your winner, the Undertaker!
The return! The dead man, as dominant as the thunder and lightning in this smile of his eyes.
Oh, he's back.
The return of the dead man at WrestleMania 20, where the Undertaker has tombstone pile driven his demented brother Kane all the way to the outskirts of hell.
Champion, and Randy Orton is in a mood.
embroiled guys in perhaps his most bizarre and strange and freakish rivalry of his entire career.
Oh, I couldn't agree with you more, Michael Cole. Randy Orton has dealt with things which we cannot explain. I don't think anybody in this world can explain. And in his pursuit to destroy the Fiend, he has been absolutely unbound.
Joe, we've seen it week after week. Randy Orton has been attacked mentally. He's been attacked physically. Randy Orton's been forced to experience out-of-body experiences based on this haunting from one entity known as the Fiend. But there may be no more dangerous superstar in WWE today. And if anybody is ready to combat the sadistic Fiend, it is indeed the apex predator, Randy Orton.
Well, to that point, Michael, it is Randy Orton who said himself, I know just how far into hell that I have to sink to remove the Fiend.
Orton muttering to himself as he heads into battle here in WrestleMania. Many distinct WrestleMania moments over the years, but nothing quite like this.
I don't often say this, but I shudder to think what these men will do to each other in this ring tonight.
Well, for me, Joe, it's what does Randy Orton have to do? We've seen Randy Orton commit some of the greatest atrocities in WWE history, but to what level must this man resort to finally end this situation with the Fiend?
Do you think Orton has an answer?
Honestly, Michael, I don't know if Randy Orton has an answer. I don't know if anyone has an answer to put an end to the Fiend. I see worry in the eyes of the Legend Killer.
I see intensity.
Not often intimidated. We have certainly seen Orton rattled the last few weeks, courtesy of the Fiend and Alexa Bliss.
What the hell is that?
And the Fiend has been restored.
It seemed momentarily, Randy Orton was just understandably frozen in time with this chilling entrance from the Fiend.
Oh, he was mesmerized, not expecting the Fiend to return in this form.
Now it becomes real. Now Randy Orton has to figure out, what is my strategy?
And the Fiend is relentless. Hideous.
And what can a strategy be against this thing?
We're going to have to see the most sadistic, the most barbaric version of Randy Orton we've ever seen, and I don't know if that's going to be enough to stop the Fiend.
Yeah, well, if Randy Orton can recover from this onslaught at the beginning of this matchup. Orton called the Fiend sick, twisted, an abomination.
Now the Fiend's gaze is firmly on Orton.
Orton can barely even make it to his feet. Orton has been completely psyched out by the Fiend.
And the Fiend looking to put Orton away, and Orton just scoots out of harm's way.
Smartly so.
I'm not even quite sure Randy knows where he is. He's at this point in time, and although the Fiend, Orton brought the Fiend outside the ring, and now Randy Orton taking advantage, and now dropping the Fiend right on the announce table.
Oh my, he's got the claw.
Mandible claw locked in by the Fiend to Orton.
Did you see that, Cole? It had no effect.
Four.
Five. And finally, the release of the mandible claw by the Fiend, but to your point, Joe, Randy Orton dropped the Fiend on our announce table. No effect happened. Nothing happened to the monster.
That didn't rock me. Uh-oh.
Look out, look out, look out. And Randy Orton now has the Fiend. Vintage Orton delivering the DDT off the second rope.
Orton just earning himself a temporary reprieve from the Fiend's attack. Oh, no.
Oh, no, he hasn't.
Look at the Fiend standing right back up like that. Randy Orton, a look of disbelief on his face.
Oh.
And went for the RKO. Fiend able to block into the Fiend, driven right into that box-like structure at ringside.
Orton's got to regroup quickly.
And Orton now with a boot to the Fiend and continues to try to punish this thing.
This vicious kicks to the Fiend's jaw.
Looking for it again.
And again, delivers his vintage DDT to the Fiend, drops him face first.
Will it keep the Fiend down this time?
And again, the Fiend slowly makes it back to his knees as Orton begins to stomp away.
Orton might be building some confidence here.
But is the Fiend impervious to pain?
It's got to be completely unnerving for Randy Orton to witness.
And Randy Orton runs right into a clothesline. The unnerving style of the Fiend. And now Orton looking to use his quickness, and what a collision. And the Fiend now pounding away on Orton.
Orton doing his best to cover up, but to very little avail.
How do you combat the Fiend?
$1 million question, Michael, we've all been asking.
Oh, and Randy Orton able to slip out of harm's way, at least momentarily. And now Orton will go back on the, well, tried to go back on the attack, but perhaps too much damage has been done. Now the Fiend set outside the ring again.
Orton able to sidestep the Fiend. But what do you,
what do you do? I mean, seriously, what do you do to keep the Fiend down?
Oh, and more just vicious, vicious kicks to the Fiend.
Keep striking, keep attacking.
And for the third time, Randy Orton gonna go for the DDT to the Fiend. The Fiend down again, and this time can Randy Orton capitalize? You saw the smile across the face of Orton. Perhaps he believes this is his moment, his opportunity.
Randy Orton staring down the Fiend.
Orton muttering to himself and now putting himself into position, as the Viper always does, to stalk and hunt the Fiend.
And now it appeared that Orton is headed to that place.
Orton's coiling up.
And the Fiend making it back to his feet once again. Went for the RKO. And then the Fiend with the mandible claw. Countered the RKO with a mandible claw.
Mandible claw cinched in for a second time.
Orton doing his best to try to struggle to the ropes, but the Fiend has him.
Yeah, but Orton's down to both knees, trying somehow to fight out of this. And the Fiend now looking for Sister Abigail.
Oh.
Not singing songs.
They were great, though. That concert was great.
He's not here to entertain us as he does in a Hollywood epic.
His movies are great, too, you know.
I can't deny that. But this is WrestleMania.
Here we go!
And Austin blocks the right hand. The Texas Rattlesnake striking with fury from the early going here. Hard right hands on the great one. Straight right hands, and Austin tells referee Earl Hebner what he thinks about him as well. Going downstairs, Austin. Oh, looking for the stunner, and the Rock dodges a big rattlesnake loaded bullet.
I think the Rock realizes this. Oh, look out, Rock! Great.
Austin must be hitting the Rock.
Rock, you gotta remember at all times you're in this match with the rattlesnake. I'll never trust him.
Out here in no man's land, away from
the
Rock right across the ring steps, face first.
Does Steve Austin not realize in general that the Rock is the leading man in Hollywood?
Well, Kim, this is WrestleMania, remember?
Yep.
This is WrestleMania.
I know it's WrestleMania. You can't mess up the Rock's, marquee face in his Hollywood career. Oh, no, look out here.
Drop all of that security wall. Taking the Rock right across our colleague, Michael Cole and Taz.
It is now.
There's their ringside table. Austin is as nasty as any human being could ever be. He is a relentless, don't trust anybody, SOB.
That's it, watch it now. Go, Rock.
Rock right there across the railing again. It has been all Austin and and what impact. What impact there. Stone cold with those cold blue eyes, sending the Rock for the ride right through hell, ending in a steel steps.
Rattlesnake is showing no respect whatsoever for the Scorpion King. watch that again. Better yet, listen to this.
Oh. We said earlier, The Rock was a member of the 1991 National Championship Miami Hurricanes, a program almost to the level of the Oklahoma Sooners. Oh, but he was a national champion. Look at Austin stomping away. Just as McMahon and Hogan was personal, just as that match was not about championships, neither is this. This is one of the great rivalries that in my 30 years in the business, I've had the privilege of witnessing. The Rock tried to cover up that head, but he was dropped from that suplex by Stone Cold. There's a cover, the hook, and The Rock kicks out.
That's a Hollywood head, JR. That Hollywood head makes millions of dollars in movies. Can't mess that head up. Look out!
Hard Irish whip with great velocity. Back to the lower back and kidneys of The Rock. And Austin again sending The Rock for a hellacious ride.
You think that the rattlesnake is jealous of the fact that Rock's a movie star?
Oh! A rocket. Austin's a wrestler. That's what he wanted to be all his life. That's what he is. He's a wrestler. As intense as any wrestler I've ever seen. I applaud The Rock being multifaceted and being a star in Hollywood. I don't know that our fans share that same sentiment, but that's another issue. That's a fan's prerogative.
Yes, the rattlesnake. I'm telling you, there's rules in the game. Oh, he's had no regard whatsoever for the rules. Oh, there you go.
And downstairs to the knee with The Rock. Austin having a conversation, but he was confronting the referee. The Rock took the opportunity with Austin's back turned to chop that knee. That was a violent chop block right to the knee, and another one by The Rock. Right after that knee, and you can see Austin wearing two knee braces. He's had a history in his career of knee problems.
And I don't know if those things are exactly legal. Those things are made out of metal. They can be used as a weapon.
Well, what the hell would you make a knee brace out of? Cotton candy? Plastic? Focusing on that knee. And he got right across the television monitor of our SmackDown colleagues. And also trying to get back up. He's got to get some circulation back in that knee.
I think our cameraman's down. Yes, he is.
Cameraman's down. We've lost Hugo Savinovich in that violent street fight with McMahon and Hogan in that bloodbath. Tables are destroyed. Bodies have been destroyed. And now can Austin.
Because it's WrestleMania. What happens at WrestleMania? That's why WrestleMania is so great.
Can Austin keep from being destroyed here by The Rock? And look at The Rock zeroing in on that leg. Relentless in his pursuit to cripple Stone Cold Steve Austin. And you gotta look at this strategically for The Rock. If Austin is down, he can't utilize the Stone Cold Stunner.
That's very smart. Smart thinking on the part of The Rock. Great strategy. I didn't agree with The Rock's opening strategy. Just to go in there, go toe-to-toe, slug it out with the rattlesnake. That wasn't smart. But now what he's doing is very smart.
Austin and his cripple stay here from that leg, and now that knee wrapped around the ring post.
Cameramen are taking a lot of abuse, aren't they?
Austin's body got to be racked in pain. But he'll never quit on you, folks. Stone Cold has never quit on any of us in his entire life inside that ring.
This is WrestleMania, and The Rock is determined to beat Stone Cold at WrestleMania. Stone Cold may have to quit tonight. This may be historic.
And an awesome fight back. Awesome dancing with what brung him. And that's that right hand. Another right hand rattles The Rock. Awesome building momentum here. Oh, but he lowered the head, and The Rock goes back downstairs with the leg. Rock taunting this crowd that at one time adored him. But they feel that The Rock has turned his back on the loyal fans of the WWE.
How do you figure that? Explain that to me.
I just said that's how they feel.
Right. Oh, I guess if they
had an opportunity. Why don't you go poll?
I guess if these fans had an opportunity to be movie stars, they wouldn't take it, would they?
Oh, look out here.
Yeah, they don't want the limousines. They don't want the money. They don't want the women that goes along with
being Sharpshooter. The move perfected by one of the greatest of all time, Bret Hart, the sharpshooter by The Rock. Austin has been in this before. Remember WrestleMania, with Austin's blood pouring down his face
with this move that Bret Hart applied so expertly. The excellence of execution, and now Austin is being perfectly executed by The Rock.
Look at The Rock. Look at those Hollywood good looks on that face of his, JR.
Austin trying to get to the ropes. I'm not worried, King, about Hollywood. For God's sakes, it ain't about Hollywood.
I guess you
think it ain't about
sellout.
It ain't about nothing but a wrestling match between two of the greatest that have ever been in the ring. And right now, The Rock has got one thing. He's going to break Austin's legs or die trying.
Yeah, that's right. Ooh, nice shot there by The Rock.
Hard right hand right to the temple. And now, Rock using that leg brace to bring Austin right back to that ring post.
Come on.
One more time and a hard right. Thunderous right hand.
Get out of the way, referee.
I'll tell you what, this is not a no disqualification match. But referee Earl Hebner is letting it go caution to the wind as far as the rules are concerned. And I'm not denigrating him for that.
Rock's tying on. Stone Cold Steve Austin's best. Everything looks good on The Rock.
Totally disrespectful.
What is that?
That's all this is a total lack of respect.
Drinking that Hollywood water.
Was that Hollywood water?
Oh, probably.
Oh, yeah, sure was.
You see all those film cameras?
Well, they lost him now.
WrestleMania, the movie.
Now they're fighting back. Reverse. Austin got reversed. Ducks the clothesline.
Close to Rock's head off.
What a collision. Both men down. Both men down from that collision.
Get up, Rock. Take that jacket off. It's unlucky. It's a jinx.
Man, you're talking about this collision here. This is some serious ass impact. Boom! Flesh on flesh, body on body. Nothing pretty about that. A hellacious physicality on display.
Come on, Rock. You got to get up. You got to do it now, Rock. Get to your feet, Rock.
Austin's up somehow, some way, and so is The Rock. The will to win permeates the bodies of both these men. A hard right hand by Austin. Another right hand. Austin connects with a right. That's three in a row for the Rattlesnake.
Oh, look out.
No reverse elbow. And the Luthez press.
Oh, no.
God bless Luthez. And the right hands by Austin.
Oh, they're being blocked.
The Rock's trying to cover up.
Block him.
Piston lock right hands by the Texas Rattlesnake.
Get in there, referee. Do your job.
Oh, hell yeah. The elbow. The elbow. The hook of the leg. Somehow, some way, the resilient Rock.
I'm gonna tell you something. Ever since The Rock put on that Stone Cold vest, he hasn't been worth a dime. Come on, Rock, get that vest on.
I think it's mud hole time.
It's huge.
And the hell with the rules.
Yeah, right.
Austin has never cared about rules. He's never said he was a role model.
Yeah, you'd probably like to have Austin as the president. If he was, the national bird would be the finger. Oh, look at this.
Great move by The Rock. The clothesline, the nip up. Austin is down.
Here you go.
And if I were The Rock, I wouldn't waste any time here on this Texas Rattlesnake.
Oh, no.
And oh, Rock bottom.
You can't do that to The Rock.
Austin just used the Rock bottom on The Rock himself.
Oh, no. This is bad.
There's a hook of the leg. And oh, no. And how humiliating and embarrassing would it be for The Rock to lose at the hands of not necessarily to Austin, but to lose to the
Rock
bottom.
Yeah, please take that vest off. Oh, look at the Rattlesnake.
Look at that intensity.
That just like snake eyes.
Inside that body beats the heart of an animal, a wrestling animal.
Watch it, Rocky, right behind you.
And the great one, the great third generation
take it off,
star.
No, take it off.
Is up.
Oh, look at The Rock. There you go.
And stunner! Oh, not the stunner.
Oh, baby.
And now will The Rock beat the Rattlesnake with the Rattlesnake's own Stone Cold Stunner.
That was precious. That was a thing of beauty, yes. Rock dug deep down and pulled out a stunner, a Stone Cold Stunner, JR. Get him over.
Rock turning Austin over, looking for a cover. And look at this arrogant cover. Oh, Austin kicked out. Oh.
out, and The Rock wanted to hear three in the worst way.
Come on, Rock. Give him another stunner. That'll be in the movie, you know. You're making WrestleMania the movie.
You wore me out with WrestleMania the movie. How many times are you going to club that?
Us movie people got to stick together. Come on, Rock. You got him.
That vest says bulletproof. The Rock has not been bulletproof thus far. But neither has Austin. Oh, Austin on one leg, back up. Ooh. The Rock connects with a big right hand. Big time right hand.
That's a little shot.
Another thunderous shot.
Come on, Rock.
Austin still standing.
What are you going to do now, Austin? What do you got left in your repertoire?
This is an amazing, amazing matchup.
He's confused now. He's thinking, oh, what can I do? If the stunner didn't work, what can I do now?
Austin back on his feet.
Oh, look at this.
This is not about a referee. It's not about a low blow. And that move backfired on Austin. He shoved the referee out of the way. And with the referee's back turned, Rock delivered a low blow.
Oh, The Rock is smart.
Way down in South Texas was that low blow.
I just want to see one people's elbow just one time tonight. Oh, wait a minute.
Austin's got the low blow, and now The Rock is thinking.
He's thinking.
And he knows probably what he's thinking about.
Yeah, it's for the people. We got 54,000 plus right here in Safeco Field, and millions watching around the world. This is for all of you people out there. The most electrifying move in sports entertainment today. The people that want to
put nobody there.
Good grief.
Austin, look with the stunner again.
No.
And The Rock's fine buster.
Now you're ready to go. Now, one more time. In the movie world, this is called a retake. People's elbow! Yes!
The Rock scores the elbow. Will it be enough? There's a cover. It's going to be over. The hook of the
leg. No, it's not. Can you not count the three referees?
The rattlesnake refuses to die.
Rock, what do you got to do? Come on, Rock.
54,097 here. And over 150 countries around our world are watching this. Our fighting men and women are watching tonight. And God bless you. You're seeing one hell of a match at WrestleMania.
Come on, Rock. Do it.
Rock talking trash. He better be wrestling and not talking here.
We'll turn around now, Rattlesnake.
Austin trying to pull himself up. And he does.
Rock bottom. That's the way it should be delivered.
The Rock bottom. It's over. The Rock. No, it's not. My God, it's not over.
Great.
My God, Austin tipped out, and The Rock can't believe it.
Look at The Rock. Look at the look on The Rock's face. Now he's wondering what it's going to take. Stone Cold has survived the Rock bottom. He survived the people's elbow. What else is in The Rock's repertoire?
How many men can you name that have tipped out of The Rock bottom? It's a short list, folks. Let me tell you, and look at the intensity of the great one.
That's a look of determination. The Rock is determined to beat Stone Cold Steve Austin here at WrestleMania. You got to do it, Rock.
Austin's knee has been ripped. He just suffered from a rock bottom.
Another
rock bottom. Austin fighting desperately out of it. And look, pull right back in. And rock bottom. Rock bottom two.
That's got to be it.
The second rock bottom. King to do with mathematics.
Come on, Rock.
Austin tipped out.
Get up, Rock. Get to your feet and stomp a mud hole in that rattlesnake. Uh-oh, look at The Rock. He's ticked now. This is it, JR.
Two rock bottoms. Austin tipped out of them both. The will to win by Austin is unparalleled. But the talent of The Rock.
Not another
unparalleled
one.
As well.
Look at The Rock. He's like the Scorpion King. He's coiled. He's coiled to strike.
Austin trying to pull himself up with every fiber in his being, with his heart racing, with his guts in knots.
You better stay
Austin
down on
trying to get up.
Stay down on the mat, Austin. You'll have a shorter distance to fall after you get this rock bottom.
Austin's up somehow, some way, and the Rock, is he gonna do it? Not the third time.
The third time's a charm. Big one.
Oh, God, a third rock bottom. A third rock bottom. A hook of the leg. And the Rock has done it.
History has been made.
Here is your winner.
Unbelievable.
It took three rock bottoms, but the Rock has finally broken the jinx. With three rock bottoms, the Rock has defeated Stone Cold Steve Austin at WrestleMania. You are looking, ladies and gentlemen, at perhaps two of the greatest. When it's all said and done, that this business will have ever offered you. They gave you everything they had here tonight, but it was three rock bottoms. And 54,000 plus, and our fans around the world have seen the Rock beat Austin for the first time at WrestleMania.
Unbelievable, but seeing and believing, and we all saw it. We saw the Rock do what you thought it couldn't be done, JR. Admit it. These 54,000 people thought it couldn't be done. They turned their backs on the Rock. They thought it sold out. But the Rock beat the Rattlesnake at WrestleMania. Finally.
What a hell of a wrestling match. We knew coming in that this would be an extraordinary night that perhaps many of us would never, ever forget. Where three rock bottoms, which is unprecedented, three rock bottoms, the Rock.
Look at the Rock.
Celebrating with his family at ringside. He has a right to be proud, like him or not. It was an amazing match with two amazing athletes. And a night that I know in my heart I will never forget.
I choose you, Roman Reigns.
We're gonna take it to a whole new level.
We run the wall!
Undertaker at WrestleMania.
And the question on the minds of everyone is, can Triple H do what his best friend Shawn Michaels was unable to do?
Well, King and Michael, No pun intended, but that's why tonight we will play this game. We will find out if the game can do what his best friend Shawn Michaels could not do.
Well, I don't know if Triple H has ever looked more impressive than he does right at this moment. He looks ready.
It's an amazing advantage when an athlete has the opportunity to train for one match and focus on one opponent.
I don't know if you guys got a chance to check out WWE.com. They have this great feature on what Triple H has gone through over the past couple of months to get ready for this matchup at a place called DeFranco's Gym. You should see the workouts that Triple H has been going through to prepare himself for The Undertaker inside the cell here tonight. The Cerebral Assassin, Triple H.
Demon of Death Valley, one of the most intimidating individuals in the history of WWE. And without a doubt, ladies and gentlemen, simply looking at this man and what's at stake, any other human being on the face of the earth would be intimidated, would be afraid of their career and their mortality. But the one man that isn't is standing in the center of the ring waiting, and that's the game.
Any superstar in history.
And that's simply because, King, of who it is, The Undertaker, 19 wins, no losses at WrestleMania. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, that the road to everlasting mortality runs through WrestleMania. And on this night, it runs through hell in a cell. just happened to the Undertaker.
Another entrance, the entrance of that demonic cell.
The two combatants in this matchup have had so much of their legendary careers shaped and molded inside this structure, the steel prison known as Hell in a Cell. There have been 24 Hell in a Cell matches in history. These two men have been in 19 of them.
And we watch right now as this Hell in a Cell envelops these two, well, three superstars.
Well, there's no doubt that same structure is morally corrupt. It awaits its victims here tonight. We're looking at them. The Undertaker, Triple H. And one thing we should note, of those 19 appearances in Hell in a Cell, The Undertaker has not won as many as The Game. The Game has won more Hell in a Cell matches than any man in history.
Yeah, he's won six in his career. Undertaker's been involved in 11, and here we go. End of an era. Triple H and The Undertaker.
How will we start this matchup? We're seeing it.
Yeah.
Physically, intimidatingly. This match could end at any moment with these heavy strikes by the most feared striker in WWE. Up and down, hard body shots. Those carcinogenic right hands of The Undertaker. So debilitating.
Certainly a different look from The Undertaker here tonight, but if you ask me, more diabolical than ever.
You know, the question, though, guys, coming into this matchup is The Undertaker's physical well-being. Remember, we have not seen him in a match in a year since the battle with Triple H last WrestleMania.
You know, I had just heard that The Undertaker started and continued cutting his hair off on a daily basis until Triple H accepted this match.
Look at The Undertaker fight back. Triple H with a flurry. Has got to fight his way back into it, does The Game. The Undertaker has an amazing threshold of pain. And on the outside, legal. Nope. Any actions on the outside. Remember, no disqualifications, no countouts.
You got to be careful what you wish for. Triple H was absolutely obsessed to have this match with The Undertaker.
You mean The Undertaker was obsessed to have this matchup with Triple H? That's one of the reasons that he cut his hair each and every day.
That's what I said, Cole.
He could not get out of his mind the fact that he did not leave this arena under his own power at last year's WrestleMania for the first time in his career.
I am of the belief that The Undertaker truly believes that figuratively he lost at WrestleMania last year after having to be carried out. Even though The Undertaker beat The Game. No one is there. Look at this. The soul.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man. It's wicked.
Oh.
It's physical.
You can feel that over here. The body of The Game hitting the floor with a thud.
The 19-0 streak started for The Undertaker all the way back at 1991 in Los Angeles when he beat Jimmy Superfly Snuka. And you guys have got to remember the type of matches that Undertaker's been through during this streak, JR. I mean, casket matches, Hell in a Cell matches, handicap matches, no disqualification.
Undertaker imposing his will early, physically, dominating The Game in the early going of this one fall to a finish Hell in a Cell encounter.
And again, the only way you win this Hell in a Cell matchup is via pinfall or submission. Inside the ring here, inside Hell in a Cell.
Well, when JR, when you said to a finish, you meant that. This is an end of an era. Wow.
And an era, ladies and gentlemen, that we will never return to. Again, hard strikes by the near 7 foot, 300 pound Undertaker. Shawn Michaels, the special official in this matchup. A man whose career was ended by the Undertaker at WrestleMania 2 years ago.
And remember, I mean, for Shawn Michaels, he really does indeed have the power to end an era here tonight. You mentioned,
I don't know how smart that was on the part of the Undertaker.
Shawn Michaels must remain unemotional in an emotional situation. That is the rite of passage of officiating.
And there's one unique note we haven't brought up tonight, JR, and this is the fact, whether it's coincidence or not, but Triple H has never lost a matchup in which Shawn Michaels has been the special guest referee his entire career.
That's a great point. And if that happens tonight, history again will be made twofold. Undertaker dictating this pace. Great. Bad ride. Worst landing. Unwanted destination for the game.
We've seen over the years, so well documented, how Undertaker is able to use this structure as a very definite weapon.
And Undertaker absolutely dominating this first part of this match.
Undertaker fully remembering how much pain and suffering he endured last year.
I don't know if I've ever seen a more physical match than these two had last year at WrestleMania, but I got a feeling inside that Hell in a Cell, this one may be even more physical.
And look at the game fight back. Whoa. Face buster by the game that seemingly didn't affect the Undertaker.
Not at all.
But that clothesline did affect Triple H.
WWE Universe here tonight at Sun Life Stadium. There's a buzz. You can hear it throughout the arena, through every step of this matchup. WWE fans on the edge of their seats.
The game has beaten them all in every generation. He can gain more immortality here tonight without question by beating The Undertaker and ending this streak.
And this is the 16th WrestleMania for Triple H.
And the 20th for The Undertaker. More than anyone in WWE history, as we go old school.
What a sight!
No spring break for The Undertaker as he stays in class, using that 300 plus off the top. Great agility.
Man, oh man.
You guys point earlier, The Undertaker has really dictated the pace of this matchup since the opening bell.
And you guys, let me say something about the officiating. If you notice, we hardly even mentioned Shawn Michaels.
Oh.
And that's a good thing when it comes to officiating.
I agree with that. And
Oh, man!
Right between the eyes. Steel ring steps between the eyes. And now one has to wonder if the game is simply on borrowed time. The base of the ring steps being placed in the ring, and certainly not for decorative purposes, quite obviously.
We saw Shawn Michaels step away as The Undertaker approached Triple H. Let's not forget about the warning The Undertaker told Shawn Michaels a number of weeks ago. He warned HBK, this match has to remain pure. Do it right, or I end you.
Say it, Cole. Here comes vintage Undertaker.
Indeed it is!
Perfectly placed. Perfectly placed. That loathsome leg drop. Right up on the apron. Across the throat of Triple H. Just imagine the impact.
Imagine that coming down on your neck. And
And the game was looking right up at the devastation, making it even worse.
All right there, DDT by Triple H, and right back in it is the game from out of nowhere.
You like the quick shot in the low abdomen, and then following it seamlessly with a DDT was the Cerebral Assassin, always thinking. But now he's got to figure a way, does Triple H, to get offensive.
Using weapons that Undertaker brought into the ring.
Well, yeah, Undertaker may be sorry about right now that he brought those steel steps into the ring.
A treacherous thud of the Undertaker's skull bouncing off the steps. Wait a minute.
Triple H maybe perhaps setting the Undertaker up for the pedigree on those steel steps.
Undertaker felt it. Oh, assisted.
Wow.
And elevated his way into a counter that will obviously prolong this match another moment or two, it would seem.
Did you see the look in Undertaker's eyes, though, after that big back body drop? It was almost a look of relief.
The Undertaker knew just how close he was to being 19-1 at WrestleMania. There is no coincidence that the Undertaker goes back to the strikes when he needs to widen the advantage. The strikes come into play.
If you're the Undertaker, you got to love the way the pace of this match has gone.
He is in no hurry. He knows exactly what he's doing. He is dismantling the game. He is decimating Triple H.
Don't think he doesn't want to punish Triple H for the punishment the game put him through last year.
I certainly would be the last man in this arena to count out Triple H.
Oh, my God.
The double A version of a spine buster, the splat of the spine of the Undertaker on the steps. Steel steps meeting a human spine.
Wow.
Look at this. Hell's Gate. Hell's Gate.
This big Triple H last year, the Hell's Gate. Undertaker's got it. He's got the submission locked in, does the Dead Man. Shawn Michaels asking his best friend if he wants to give it up. And God.
Look at this, Triple H.
Oh, that strength. Sinful strength, Mike. Triple H, the cover!
Well, the one thing that saved Triple H there, I believe, is the fact that Undertaker's back was on the steps.
Watch this again.
And right here, the spine, the lower back, and then the strength, the raw, animalistic strength of the game.
That is survival mode.
I have never seen anyone ever.
Wait a minute.
Game, obviously.
He's already pulled out of one steel chair.
All legal.
There's another.
Steel steps, and now two chairs in the ring. Oh. Hard shot downstairs. Crack right again on the spine. The cerebral assassin going back to the spine. No wasted motion by this man.
Wounds beginning to show already on the face of Triple H as this matchup continues.
Superhuman results are achieved by perseverance and heart. And we're seeing that from the game here and now.
Watch out, it hurts.
Again, all this is legal.
Yeah, as if that demonic structure weren't enough.
Don't need those.
You've got steel steps, metal chairs.
Hell in a Cell is a lawless entity, ladies and gentlemen, with no rules.
No, look at
The spine again. It's as if there's a large bullseye that has been figuratively drawn on the spine of the Undertaker.
Oh, man.
Triple H has taken over after that spine buster on the steps.
Again
on the spine. Not the legs, not the head, not the shoulders, but the spine.
Wait a minute. That's too much.
A vile, vicious, malicious attack.
Even Shawn Michaels said it's too much.
How can it be too much when there are no rules?
Exactly.
And now the edge of the chair.
You want to win, but you don't want to destroy this man.
He has to do this.
I think Triple H made it clear.
You want it done, and you end it. Just come around. It doesn't have to be like this. Just come. You know he's not going to quit. Come around.
Triple H refusing to cover the Undertaker.
Thank you, it's one match. Come on. Let me.
Oh, reversal and continuing his onslaught with a steel chair.
And you end it! End it! Or I will!
Please, come on.
Don't stop it. Don't stop it. Do not stop it.
The least. We're here fighting up. We've got his soul, his heart on display. The dead man riseth.
No.
And the dead man goes down again.
And Triple H is going to end it.
Finally the cover. Finally the cover. Will it be? The streak will end. Oh, it will not end. At least it will not end now. Obviously out to prove that he can do.
Let me ring the bell. I'm ringing the bell. Please let me ring the bell.
That, what Shawn Michaels could not do, but The Undertaker adamant that he will not quit.
Oh my God.
That may have answered all questions.
The jaw.
Emphatically, the knockout shot and the hand. No! My God! My God, how close was that? Sledgehammer shot, scintillating to the face of The Undertaker. And the nearest near fall we can remember. Watch.
Boom! Locked in.
Come on, Sean. Sean's got to get up here. The official's down. Sean.
Yeah, but the game is not tapping. He's grabbed that sledgehammer.
A weapon in hand.
And he's lost it.
The game may be fading. Remember, he escaped it earlier to the game by lifting the Undertaker.
He does not have the strength now.
And he doesn't have the leverage now either.
The game is finished.
Oh, my, he's got it again.
The Undertaker is torturing Triple H.
Triple H is down and out.
That's it.
The malignancy of the Hell's Gate. And the face of the Demon of Death Valley.
Triple H is faded, completely faded. But the referee's down.
Triple H is defenseless. He is out. The Undertaker has utilized Hell's Gate.
Look at this carnage.
The vanquish is full, but
look at this. Another official, Charles Robinson, coming out of the ring, but he's got to get inside the cell here. That cell's been locked shut.
The referee is unlocking the cage, obviously. We need an official in the ring.
This mess to
continue. Undertaker makes his way back up. Choke slam! Cover! The count of three!
Yes!
Now getting kicked out!
Did he get him? What?
The Undertaker, with a look of astonishment, a miraculous look on his face, thought he had the game after Hell's Gate and a choke slam.
How did Triple H survive there?
Toughness. That is toughness. The will and the passion to win. And the kill!
Frustration, desperation.
It looks like we've driven on the scene of a car accident. There's bodies everywhere.
This is absolutely amazing here. What?
20 feet of carnage. The game makes his way up.
Oh, no.
It slips up. Oh!
Oh!
Straight team music. Straight team music.
Look at this.
Straight team music.
Streak's over!
They've done it! It's not over! The streak lives! And Michaels! Pause.
Shawn Michaels has been calling this matchup down the middle. He was gonna ring the bell to take Taker out of it. And then he was put at the Hell's Gate.
Michaels was put into a very tough position for Mr. WrestleMania to be in.
His emotions overwhelming him.
Watch this kick. Bam! Downtown. A slumber knocker. A sweet chin music. And then the pedigree.
And somehow, amazingly, the Undertaker still lives. Look at this.
The Undertaker will not die. On April 1st, 2012, he will not die. And now sledgehammer in hand once again. The demolition continues. The carnage ensues.
The referee, Shawn, back on his feet. Triple H on his feet.
The emotion overcoming the game with his obsession.
Oh, no!
Oh, my God! Assaulted from every angle. The game here in this exchange. Look out.
This is it.
Oh, no.
Tombstone. The Undertaker with a tombstone. Will it be? Can it be? And it's
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. I can't believe what I'm seeing.
Neither can the Undertaker. Can the 78,000 plus in attendance. Neither can Shawn Michaels.
The perseverance and the display by these men. And Shawn Michaels is an emotional wreck.
Can you blame the man? Triple H is his best friend. He has tremendous respect for The Undertaker, the man who retired him. He's caught in the middle of this. He's torn.
Shawn Michaels may be an emotional wreck, but both The Undertaker and Triple H are physical wrecks.
Hell in a Cell changes careers. Tonight, it is changing lives. It may be destroying friendships. But it is, ladies and gentlemen, the end of an era.
Oh.
The headbutt retaliated by The Game.
How on earth, how much more can these two men have? Oh.
The human anatomy cannot take much more. Whose will is greater? Whose heart is beating stronger?
How these men even back on their feet?
Unbelievable, I don't know.
It is absolute unadulterated passion.
Every person in the stadium.
I've never seen a display of courage and guts like we're seeing here tonight.
And this is exactly the way it should be between these two. Who can survive?
Overhand right. And another one for the tape fist of The Game. Finding his mark. The Undertaker staggering.
Oh, no.
Undertaker trying to count.
Look at this.
Pedigree. Yes.
Another pedigree. Michaels going to uncount the cover.
The throw and he kicked out.
Going to get three. How close was that? How close could you get without getting a three? And Michaels still is so perplexed or
conflicted, I think.
Conflicted is what I was trying to say, but hell, I'm just as excited as the fans. This is unbelievable.
This sold-out crowd is witnessing history tonight, witnessing the end of an era. Listen to this place.
And I'll tell you what, you can, at some place, somewhere, this match will end. I don't know when, I don't know how. You can check out a Hell in a Cell, but after tonight, can you truly ever leave? The Undertaker stirring. Look at his back.
Oh,
look at the Undertaker's back.
He was hammered.
That's that steel chair attack from Triple H, who's now reaching, desperately trying, clawing.
Oh, he's got it.
The sledgehammer could now, without question, be the difference. With the streak of 19-0 on the line in jeopardy.
Yeah, but Undertaker with a weapon as well.
Oh, boy. Which one of these men is going to have the strength to brandish those weapons? That's the question. Undertaker's to his feet.
Who will execute whom in this matchup? And the Undertaker's got a weapon.
Oh, look at that.
Foot.
Look at that.
Through the foot. The Undertaker stepping on the sledgehammer and set.
Oh,
head shake. No. Chair may be more deadly than those shots.
Oh.
And you can hear the shots. Now the Game spine is being assaulted and attacked.
Look at Shawn Michaels. Every one of these blows.
Now Michaels may have to consider stopping this match to save his friend. What the hell on the floor. An amazing ride.
I said these two men must be superhuman, but there's got to be a limit to what a human body can stand.
More noxious, hazardous chair shots from the ruthless Undertaker. Hell bent on retaining.
Look at the chair.
Undertaker covers at the chairs. Michaels counting
still.
And Triple H again refusing to
bother to come on. Stop.
Look at the damage.
This may not
Does one really win inside Hell in a Cell, or does one really survive?
Watch out, watch out, watch out here. Triple H is fully aware of the danger he's in. He is trying to use get that sledgehammer.
Triple H doesn't even have the strength to lift that hammer now.
The game writhing in pain.
Stay
no
out.
Human being should have to suffer in this manner. The game lunging, but there's not enough gas left in the tank. Undertaker shaking his head. And the game defiant, courageous. Still, his mind says, I will fight you. I will fight you.
Yeah, but his body is saying something else.
Oh! One last act of defiance.
And the shot heard around the world with a sledgehammer. Undertaker disposes of that and is the game next on the disposal list. The way this one has gone, who knows? Triple H trying to use the Undertaker's arm and legs to pull the game up to regain his vertical balance.
Yeah, he's pulling himself right into a more precarious position. Look at this.
Oh, God. Oh, God. We know what that means.
Yes, we do.
The signified. The sign. Oh, a disaster. An abhorrent. Sean's gonna count. The tombstone, the count, and the three. A God, what a war.
Now the winner of this match,
The Undertaker.
Oh, I'll tell you, in 4 decades of sitting at ringside, honestly say I have never, ever witnessed anything like what we have just seen.
The Undertaker is 20-0 at WrestleMania.
Look at the Undertaker's back. Fighting to get back up. The era has ended. We will never see it again. And what a way to go. See Shawn Michaels compete in the ring again, thanks to The Undertaker. But the question remains, will we ever see The Undertaker compete again? Will we ever see Triple H compete again? The one thing we can't answer conclusively,
this
is the end of an era.
Look at this.
Extraordinary respect by Shawn Michaels and by over 78,000 here tonight at WrestleMania.
It's as if these three men know that They will never be at the same place at the same time in this exact environment. History was made here tonight at WrestleMania 28. Ladies and gentlemen, is respect. Without question, mutual respect. Looking back here just moments ago, and it looked like there was nothing left for the game. He kept trying. He willed his way back into it. He's going to try to use the sledgehammer. Boom. One more time, but it was not to be. And then this, you heard the results, you heard the sound, and the game finally won at last. Valiant attempt to utilize the sledgehammer. And it was not to be. The defiance, the last act of defiance.
And following this, the final act of defiance.
You gotta finish me off. I will not die. You must finish me off. And the Undertaker, perhaps in a perverse show of respect, did exactly what the game requested. Emphatically, with the best that the Undertaker could bring, the Tombstone Piledriver. And Shawn Michaels counted to three.
And finally, in the Undertaker's mind, he gets what is his. Vengeance.
A standing ovation from 78,363 in a moment that will live in infamy in WWE, an image we can never replicate, an an image that we will all remember forever.